This episode of Earl Grey is brought to you by Audible.com, offering more than 180,000 titles for smartphone, tablet, and desktop. To get a free audiobook of your choice and help Trek FM at the same time, visit audibletrial.com/trekfm. And also by Enterprise in Space, an international program of the nonprofit National Space Society. Find out how you can help science and education and become a virtual crew member aboard the NSS Enterprise Orbiter by visiting enterpriseinspace.org.
You're listening to Trek FM.
Theo Greyhawk.
Hello and welcome to another cup of Earl Grey, Trek FM's dedicated podcast to the next generation. I am your excessively laughing host, Richard Marquez, for the last time on this podcast. And here with me, as always, like I said for the last time, is the amazing Amy Nelson and the incredible Justin Ozer. How are you guys doing?
Oh my gosh, are you going to lead with that? Oh, it's the last time. Wow. Everyone, hope you sat down for that because that's some news.
Yeah, well, that's the first surprise. Hi, Richard. I'm doing fine. That's the first surprise for our listeners. But Amy and I are going to get some surprises because you have something very special for us today, right?
I know. Absolutely. So curious.
Absolutely. It's going to be freaking epic. I will tell you that. So as you guys heard, yes, this is my grand finale from Earl Grey. But rest assured, this will not be the last time you will hear from me. Cue the groan from the audience.
No.
But before we start the adventure, my co-hosts are here with me, and there are two special guests that Amy and Justin do not know who they are.
We really don't. We have no idea. They're masked behind some mysterious names right now, and Richard revealed nothing to us.
Yes, their ranks. They're hiding behind their ranks.
So this will be a surprise.
So, but what? So I already told them that I'm going to introduce them like wrestling stars. So bear with me. So, and I'm a huge fan of wrestling, no matter how fake it is. All right. So our first guest is coming from the frozen moon of Andoria is Senior Chief Petty Officer Theosif Therhat, or in the real world, this is my brother, the brilliant Nathan Marquez. How you doing, Nate?
And I am sorry. I'm here.
So Amy knows my brother.
But, yes, we Justin met at the wedding.
Yep, that's right. So good times. So and then our second guest is, this guy does not need an introduction. He's one of my best friends. Coming from the Teller Prime planet is Master Chief himself, Renkonk. Jav Wenkrum. I don't know why I spelled it like that. Or, like I said, my best friend, Alvin Schaff. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good, but I can't start my video. You have to start it.
Uh-oh.
There we go.
There we go.
Hello.
Hi,
how
Alvin.
Good. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Well, as you guys just heard, my best friend Alvin and my brother Nathan is going to be joining us for this adventure. So we've been ready to go for the last 2 hours, and I'm excited.
Yeah, it's very exciting.
Awesome. Okay, well, here we go.
Previously on Earl Grey.
Our heroes picked up an unusual signal emanating from the Secure system deep inside the Cardia Nebula within the Shackleton Expanse. The runabout, Susquehanna, was initially dispatched to investigate, but the crew failed to report and was presumed lost. Starfleet dispatched the USS Venture, a Galaxy-class starship that Amy, Justin, and Miguel were assigned to.
May he rest in peace. Here. Are we going to have a funeral for him on this one?
We'll see. The vessel's best hope to solve this mystery, our gallant away team took off with haste to the planet's surface on a shuttlecraft. Meanwhile, as they're descending to the surface, they were attacked by another interested party, Romulans. After an exchange of phaser fire, Amy was forced to make an emergency landing. Both Justin and Miguel were injured. Both without comms, our heroes journey to the planet's surface towards the Romulan wreckage. But as they began their journey, they stumbled upon some of the dead crew of the Susquehanna. Continuing their adventure, they found that the Romulans had already abandoned their crashed shuttlecraft, like our crew, and began to follow the faint signal. Our crew follows the Romulan tracks to the end, being attacked by giant bugs. After defeating the bugs, they stumble on a settlement of Maki, where they are taken prisoner by their leader, Elrod Davlet. I can't remember how I pronounced it. able to convince the leader to follow the signal, our heroes stumble on an obelisk. But before they were able to decipher it, they were attacked by the missing Romulans from the crashed shuttlecraft. Unfortunately, Miguel was vaporized, and our heroes were saved by the USS Venture crew.
And now the continuation.
Amy and Justin are behind cover as the security team from the USS Venture mops up the rest of the Romulans. Commander Stewart, man, you guys are about to be goners. It's a good thing we came when we did.
Yeah, and Q helped too.
We're glad we could get here in time.
Yeah, maybe we should have contacted the ship. Oh well, lessons learned.
Well, we got to handle it down here. How about you two head back to the Venture and get some R&I? When you're ready, come on back down. Wait, weren't there three of you?
Oh, it's a tragic story. We lost one.
Yeah, it was very sad. Poor Miguel.
That's a shame. We'll have to have a memorial for him when the dust settles.
Yes.
Off you guys go. All right, so then Amy and Justin are beaming aboard the Venture. Alvin, you're up. I'm going to call you guys by your names because it's just going to get very confusing.
Yes, thank you.
So, okay. Alvin, you're up, buddy. You're going to be at the controls for the transport. So FYI for the listeners, so I have a game board that's set out that I'm going to be replacing the tiles as we go. And basically, they have their own figures who both of them have seen. So, yeah. So, Alvin.
Yes.
Since you're at the controls, let's do three die. Okay, here we go. So, we're going to do, it's going to be control and engineering. So, you need to roll a 7 or better. For each person that you're beaming aboard. So
beaming
their lives are in your hand.
Don't mess. I don't want to have a transporter accident. Jeez.
I don't want to kill somebody my first day, so.
Okay.
You said 7 or more for both?
Yep.
I've got 37.
No. Just read off each die.
Oh, 20, 13, and 5.
I was hoping for a transporter accident.
You're gonna kill us already.
All right,
already?
So that's gonna be for Amy. All right, so do it again. Do it one more.
Oh, okay.
You're gonna do it for each player.
16, 10, and 3.
Uh-oh, that's gonna be for Justin as well. Okay, so since you did a 3 on the other one,
okay.
And then what was the other one for Amy was 5?
20, 15, and 5 or something. Close.
All right. So the transportation was actually successful, but The problem is that now Amy and Justin have a headache, and they are actually distraught from the from your shifty beaming on the controls.
Must be Miguel's Sorry, revenge dude. Or his headache last time.
Yes.
Ow, that really hurts.
As a beta said, I have no sympathy for you right now.
Okay. Well, at least we're alive.
Yeah, there you go. All right. So as the rest, as my crew here can see now, we're in the transporter room, and the one on the left is going to be Amy, and the one on the right, and I'll move you guys, obviously. And then, of course, the red shirt is Nate, and then the yellow shirt is Alvin. So.
I love it.
And you guys.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Sorry about the headaches, but, you know, you're here alive, so that's all that matters.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you for bringing us aboard, and we'd like to see the rest of the ship.
Would you like to do intros?
Oh, I thought we had. Sorry. Hi, I am... Do I say my name?
You can. It's up to you. It doesn't matter to me.
All right. So, hi, I am Lieutenant Junior Gray Delara Nellen. I'm from Betazoid.
And hi, I'm Lieutenant Kel Bellin, originally from Trill.
Well, hello, I'm Master Chief Petty Officer Rinkog Jav Winkum from Tellarite.
We'll just call you Master Chief from here on out.
Yeah, we'll just call me Master Chief.
And I am Senior Chief Petty Officer Thasiv Thorhut.
So we'll just call you Senior.
Andor.
We'll just call you, we'll call you by your name, but yeah. All right, well, I'm glad you guys got the intros down.
Nice to meet you. Hey, there's no humans in this room. That's kind of interesting, right?
Oh, yeah. Idic.
That was not done on purpose either. All of a sudden, the lights go out. What do you do?
Hey, who turned out the lights?
Is there a power surge? What's going on here? We need to go to some controls and figure out what's happening.
Or maybe we could search the room with some insight to know where the light switch is.
Computer, lights?
If only if that was that easy.
There's no switch.
There's no light switch.
You just...
What?
So we need to get to a console and see what's happening, or contact the bridge.
Yeah, Justin? Let me try to tap my comm badge and contact the bridge.
That inaudible sound that it makes when it doesn't work.
Oh, yeah.
Lieutenant Nellen, can you try yours in case it's just mine that's having a problem?
Yes. This is Amy to the bridge. It's not
Nothing.
Working. What are we going to do? We need to get out of this room. We need to get to either engineering or to the bridge, guys. Where do you want to go?
Well, we can use my engineering values to get us there.
Oh, cool. Excellent.
All of a sudden, their emergency lights come on. You can barely see. You can barely see 10 feet in front of you. The red light, whatever it's called, emergency. Yeah.
The generator.
So there
came
you go.
On.
Yep, the backup generator came on.
All right, Master Chief, we're gonna follow your lead. Can you get us to engineering?
I can try. Oh, I'm trying to figure this out.
Which door do you want to go through?
Let's go through the left door.
This one?
Yes, correct. We're going to go to the left.
Door doesn't open. Hey, power went out, dude.
Right.
Come on.
Let's try the door to the right.
Power, the door doesn't open either.
Okay.
Is there any kind of console that we can...
Nope,
like
just emergency light. No panels are no
it's,
panels
it's a transporter
are.
There's got to be a transporter console we can try to see if it can turn on.
Yeah, there's one on the other side of the transporter.
Oh no. That's actually a room.
Oh, okay.
That's just another room. Yeah.
Right, yes,
sorry.
But I thought
it's not actually a part of it.
The 24th century had a transporter console.
Yeah, it's right in front of right here.
Okay, yeah. Can we try to touch that and see if anything happens?
It's dark.
Hmm. Okay. We gotta get out of this room.
Can we like blow up the door?
Oh yeah.
Yes. Well, what do we have on us?
I have a phaser.
Okay.
I have a phaser.
Oh man, I didn't know we're gonna explode things.
No, we're just gonna. Cut
through the door.
Yeah.
I have a compression rifle.
That's a little much.
Okay, we could try to bring the console back online with my toolkit.
Oh.
Hmm.
Okay. Justin,
that sounds
what do
like
you
a
think?
Good idea.
Okay, so you're gonna to open the door with your engineering kit, you're gonna need control and engineering. So that's 9, 10, 12. You're gonna need to do a 3 die, 12 or higher.
Okay, so each die has to hit 12 or higher.
Right. For now, if that's what you want to do, you could do other things like I don't know, jimmy the door.
Yeah, why don't I just jimmy the door instead of wasting my food?
Well, you're still going to have to use one anyway.
Well, then we'll
So it's either jimmy the door or it's use the or try to use it on the console.
I'm going to try to use my toolkit on the console.
Okay. All right. Okay. All right, go ahead and roll.
18, 11, and 8.
Partial power comes on to the console.
All right, we've got partial power, so let's see if we can...
It flickers and all that kind of stuff.
Stabilize it, or jimmy the door now, or contact the bridge.
You already tried that.
Oh. Well, I thought now that we had partial power.
Oh, I guess you didn't try it. Yeah, you could try it again. Is that what you want to do? I'm gonna try not to give you guys any hints or anything like that. That's why I brought those two along, because Nate has D&D experience. Alvin doesn't. He's just here for comedy relief.
I thought I was here for comedy relief.
Well, I think we should try and at least get out of here instead of just
Since
so do you want to blow up the door?
No, but since we have partial,
I think
power.
You should blow up the door. I think that would be far more interesting.
Yes, but before you blow up the door, wouldn't it make sense that our Master Chief here, who has some engineering experience, can, you know, try to look at the console and see if there's anything that can be helped for contacting the bridge or operating the transporter to get us to another part of the ship?
I don't know. No one tried it.
Let's go ahead and try that with my engineering experience. I will view the console to see if we can get a message out.
Okay.
All right. So that's what you're doing?
Yes,
that's what I'm going to do.
Okay, so there's only partial power. There has been a disruption outside the ship, and there has been some kind of dampening field that's going on around the ship. So makes communication impossible. Mm. Communication to the bridge is impossible, and... Try not to sneeze. Sorry. like partial power is all over the ship. So there are going to be some rooms that are going to be inhospitable to human life or alien life.
Okay.
And yeah,
this sounds like something I read that happened a few years back on the Enterprise.
But it's also a way to keep you out of certain doors too.
Yeah.
We're going to get out.
Okay, so we need to get out of here. Let's.
Well, since that didn't work, let's jimmy open the door.
All right, which door do you want to go through?
Let's go for the right now.
This one or that one?
No.
The right door.
The right
door on the right.
Screen.
Correct.
Yep.
Oh,
yep,
got it.
Yep. Yeah.
Let me find that tile. Hold on a second. Thought you're going to go to the left. All right, so what do you get? All right, so I need you to roll me. So that's gonna be a simple task. So that doesn't require a token. So go ahead. Let's go ahead and do three. Let's do control engineering again.
Control engineering. So 12 or higher.
12. Yep.
Unsuccessful. 1, 1, and 16.
Oh.
I should blow the door up.
Yeah, I think we're getting there.
Yeah.
It sounds like it.
Definitely.
Well,
yeah, I have a hand phaser. Yeah.
You can't open the door. It doesn't open.
I say we use force.
Yeah, and I would suggest we start with the phaser before the compression rifle. We don't know what's beyond the door, and maybe compression rifle's too much.
Okay, so who's going to do it?
I will.
Okay, Amy's going to do it.
I have a type 2.
Okay, so that's going to be daring and security. So that's 11. Yeah. So, okay. Which door are you going to do it on? The right door?
No, we're going left. We're going original.
Let me get my board. Hold on a second. All right, go ahead. All right. So roll me.
Alvin, we need 11.
Okay. 15, 8, and 7.
The door, the right panel opens and that's it.
What do you mean?
So the phaser wasn't strong enough, guys.
Wait. What do you,
no,
what
no,
do you
no,
mean?
No. It opened,
like,
but the
right half of it opens?
Of the door, yeah. Uh-huh.
Then why don't we squeeze through?
Okay.
There you go. Are you guys going through? Fit. Okay.
Yeah. You're going to squeeze through.
Okay.
At least we didn't get sucked into space or anything.
Yay, another room.
This is so cool.
Wow. Oh, this is a huge room. Cool. Well, I guess we're stuck in a tiny room right now.
Yeah, well, yeah. Technically, you don't know what's on the outside of this, but yeah, it's okay.
So we're all going to get to know each other right now in this room.
All right. So is there lights, partial lights? Do we have emergency
partial lights? Partial lights throughout the whole entire ship. Yep.
Okay. Well, we're out of the room. Now what are we going to do?
Actually, it looks pretty well lit in here.
I say we try and search the room, or at least if there's nothing here, just keep on continuing forward until we can get to the bridge.
Yes.
I concur. Let's search the room.
Okay. So what room are we in? Look around. All right.
So from here on out, I'm going to make it 5 or higher. You have to make 5 or higher to open the door now.
Okay.
So it's not going to be like 12 or 11 or something like that. So
okay.
Well, with Alvin's rolls, we would never get anywhere.
That is true. That's very true.
That room was safe. Right, that's why I want to stay there.
Oh. Okay. So what room are we in?
Who's searching?
You guys are in the...
Need to roll to search?
I can...
Yeah, go ahead. And then after that, it's obviously, there's nothing in that room. As you can
see. Well, then let's go through the door. We didn't find anything.
Which door?
Only one.
The only door that's there?
No, there's 3 doors.
There's 3 doors.
Doesn't the third one lead back to where we came from? Or no?
Actually, technically, there's 4 then.
There's 4 doors. The one that we came through.
Oh, I see. Yeah, there's one we came through. And then there's one.
Oh, yeah. 2
clocks. So I say we do not straight. So either... Do you see?
I say diagonal left.
Let's go
diagonal left then.
Not that one.
This no.
One?
Yeah.
Not
so
that
I guess
one.
The master.
No,
the one below it.
The closet, like
room. There you go.
Yes, that one. That
yes.
One.
Okay. All right, Alvin.
Okay,
so I guess you're the door opener.
11, 17, and 18. So we made it.
All right.
We made it through.
Wow, what a mission defined by opening doors.
All right, Alvin, what do you see? What room are you in now?
It looks to be a personal quarters. We should search it for equipment.
There is a computer console on the left-hand side, and there's a smooth wall on the right side.
I assume there's no one in there that we're startling because it's personal quarters? You don't see anyone?
No, I don't see anybody.
Oh, good.
It's like they left in a hurry.
It's not a personal quarters. It's actually a science console.
Oh, okay.
Oh, it's a science console.
Good thing we have the science
They look
engineer
alike.
There.
Well, then
okay,
I'm going
so,
to...
Go ahead. Oh. Well, what equipment is there that we can take?
Well, there's a science console. I think we should search it to see if it's working.
Well, yeah, we can see that. I think we need to either find a way... Did we find out before that there's this dampening field and so our comm badges won't work anywhere in the ship, or it was just part of the ship?
It's the entire ship.
The comm badge is entire ship, so.
The entire communication network
is
down.
So if we want to get if we've already found out some information, we're just looking to find out more that'll help us navigate through the ship? Is that what we're trying to do?
I want to see if there's a way to restore comms, even though there's damping.
Okay, so if you're going to do that, then that's going to be same thing, control in engineering. So that's 12. Okay, so 12. Again.
Alrighty. We're going for it. 11, 16, and 17. So I'm one away.
You partial power comes back to the... Wait. Are you guys all in the room? Or are you guys all stuck in...
I mean, if you open the door, we should all be in there, right? Or no?
I feel like we should all be in here, but...
You guys want to all be in there?
They didn't want to be with me, so I went.
Yeah, well, you only moved Alvin, so... Nate? We're all together.
You're all together?
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm going to stay back because I don't trust this room.
Oh.
All right. Andorian distrust.
Partial power comes back onto the console, to the science console. It plays a message, a personal message. Ensign Gwen Sandy.
Personal log, stardate 48649.9. I can't believe we're deep in the Shackleton Expanse. My mom always told me space is beautiful, but she never told me it was this beautiful. The Carnia Nebula is so much more beautiful up close than from a telescope on Earth. You feel more connected to the nebula and so beautiful and perfect as it is. I would like to think.
Critical error. Computer malfunction. All of a sudden, the door slams right behind Alvin, Amy, and also Justin. Neurocene gas starts to fill the room.
What
do you do? What do you do?
Can we Nathan jump through the other door?
No, nope, you guys are trapped in there.
There's
on the
only
other
one
side.
Door there.
Can we? Don't there, I thought there was another door coming out of it. Anyway, but can we do something on the console to try to stop the gas from coming in?
Nope, the power went out on the computer already.
Can we can we shout through and say "Help us!" for the guy that we left behind?
Okay, no, we're phasering that door.
Phaser the door.
Alvin, don't you have the? We
but
gotta
what
blow
happened,
it up.
What happens when a phaser goes through neurozine gas? Is that bad? Do we know?
Well, it's either that or die.
You don't die. You just get
yes, it's flammable. It's extremely flammable.
Don't say that.
Well, then I guess we're gonna break down this door with strength.
With strength, you're gonna bust down the door with strength.
I don't know.
Our strongest person is.
I love it. No,
door.
No. I love it. Is that what you're gonna do?
That's what I'm gonna do.
Okay, that's gonna be a token. Okay, so that's gonna be daring and security.
Fitness.
Oh, fitness. Oh, no. It's gotta be attributes and discipline. There has to be one of each. So.
I've got security and daring.
Yeah, I would say.
No, I got no. I'll fitness and security. Yeah, fitness
okay,
and security.
So
that's gonna be.
I have to roll an 11.
11. 11 or higher.
Okay.
You're just taking all the.
Jeez. 16, 2, and 4, unsuccessful.
Oh.
Darn it.
Well, I guess we're going to be knocked unconscious.
Justin and Amy both pass out.
Oh, man.
Can't
Alvin's
the only
one.
Alvin's
the only one. Alvin's the only one.
What's happening on the other
that's
side?
That's up.
Or is it his fault? Did he lock us in here?
Ooh, the plot thickens.
Alvin's the only one that's standing, is still standing up and breathing.
Did he not get knocked unconscious?
Does it not affect
nope.
Tellarites
nope.
the same way? Yes, okay.
Okay, well, okay. Then I guess I should probably use a toolkit to get this door open.
There you go. You should try again instead of doing brute force. So let's do control in engineering.
Sweet. I don't have to roll 12 now. I can't even roll 11.
Our lives are hanging in the balance, I'm just
we're
saying.
We're not dead. We're just unconscious.
That was my Betazoid sensing to Alvin.
It's our passive
sure.
ability.
You know, even though we're unconscious, we're using that Betazoid link for us to exchange information right now, right?
That's yep. right.
Well, we've got bad news, guys. I rolled a 14, 19, and a 4. Hmm. Can I at least get the door partially open?
Yeah.
You passed out now. It's up to Nate now. It's up to Nate now.
Nate, I'm sending you my empathic vibes. Help us.
Okay. All right. I'll try and open the door because I just hear screaming and then you guys collapse. So I feel like something went wrong.
Okay.
That's a good feeling.
Control.
everything's cool. That's a good feeling. Right. Don't worry.
Let's go with control and security. So that's a 7 for you, Nate.
Okay. I need someone to roll for me.
Oh.
Why doesn't Richard roll this one? Because I don't want to.
A 7. Yeah.
15, 12, and 9.
Woohoo!
Nate opens the door with brute strength and yeah.
Andorian power.
He rips open the door because he's an Andorian. He finds Amy, Justin, and Alvin passed out on the ground. The neurozine gas funnels through onto the ground. It's a low gas. It filled the room up a little bit on the ground. What do you do, Nate?
Okay. I would try and pull them out of the room.
Okay. And you did.
Okay.
Okay, pull so us out of that room.
Get me out of that room.
They're all knocked out, so you gotta do something.
Can I slap one of them?
How does that help pull us out of the room?
Go ahead, slap one. Like, go ahead, slap you one. Awake. Slap one. Then. That's daring, because I don't think you're gonna get far with Amy when you do that.
This is already more violent than the previous episode, and we're just going room to room. Okay.
Let's go with daring because of how brave he is to try that. And let's go with it's a command decision because it might be a poor one. So we'll see. So 6.
A 6?
So yeah, 6. All right. 16, 16, and 1. So Nate slaps Amy and also Justin, and they both revive.
Ah, what the hell are you doing?
Does not.
What happened?
Well,
what's going on?
But
I didn't have water on me. I just thought, I had to get you guys up somehow.
All right.
Well, thanks I'll for saving us you. And pulling us out of the
now
room.
Now I've got a huge headache, though. I've got a migraine.
Alvin's still unconscious.
Yeah, don't worry about him.
Well, he's our science guy, so can't Amy take a look at him with her engineering
guy.
Medical
he's
background?
Your engineering guy.
Yeah.
Okay, so I have a focus on survival, so can I survive him?
Okay. Survive me. Please survive me.
So let's go with control and medicine. So a 10 or higher.
All right. Give me a 10 or higher.
All right. I'll take the roll for this one.
It's your life.
Well, it's her. It's her, not you.
Okay. She rolled a 16, 18, and 19.
Woohoo!
Yay! And Alvin's back up.
What the hell happened in there, guys?
I don't know.
Well,
there was
we
some...
were watching a message, and then some gas came out. Not quite sure why.
Then we got knocked out, and this guy over here slapped us. But I guess we're okay. So,
well, I had to wake you up somehow. I freaked out.
But is there still gas coming through that door? Should we close that door over there?
Yes, I think we should.
Yes,
just in case.
Yes.
Yeah, we should All definitely right. close that door.
All right, Nate, close the door. No big deal.
Okay. So that door wasn't good.
So you're out of there.
So there's obviously something with this nebula. I wonder, because we're in close proximity, if the nebula is having something to do with our power issues.
Yeah, but the gas, that would seem to mean that there's some hostile force on here that wants to subdue everyone, doesn't it?
Well, maybe that's coming from the nebula, that there's life forms in the nebula that want us to go away.
And also, why do we have gas that can knock people out? It seems weird, but maybe it's helpful sometime.
Yeah. Maybe it's just in the ventilation system. Yeah. We should probably...
But how did the gas get in the vents? I don't think it would be from the nebula.
Well, if there's beings...
Maybe there's
in
some
the
beings that want to subdue us and take
Alien
over the ship.
Alien life form, yeah.
You never know. You know, we tend to come across a lot of weird beings out here. Never know.
So we really need to get... to somewhere engineering
I think we go through the door in front of us not to the
okay.
Okay. Yep.
So let's have Nate use his brute strength to do that as he opened the other door.
Just have him smash all the doors until we get to the bridge. Game over.
Hulk smash.
Okay, is that what you want to do?
Yeah.
Okay. So
yeah, let's just.
Okay, five or higher.
You rolled 11, 14, and a 4. So, right,
so
the door opens and breaks apart, but Nate got a splinter.
Oh. A door splinter? These aren't made out of wood, are they?
They're carbon fiber.
Ouch.
Splinter.
Ouch. Okay, well, he can suck it up. He'll be fine.
Yeah, we got to figure out what's
going on. Maybe he shouldn't slap people. That's
yeah.
What he gets.
Your precious hands.
Can we look around the room and just see what we've see? Because it's always good to look.
Yes,
it is. So as you're looking around, you see two couches, one on each side, one door going it looks like another room, and then of course a door in front of you.
Find anything in the couches? Did we check the cushions?
No.
We have no money in this society, so that's
yeah. There's no coins in there, okay?
Quarter? I don't know what you're talking
but
about.
But that would be a good loot chest.
Oh, that's funny. Okay.
I'm glad you said that. That's a good loot chest idea, actually. That is a loot chest. Go ahead.
Okay. Does going front? There looks like panels there. But I'm interested to also see another piece of the game board.
No, there's no panels. It's just a door in front of you, a door on each side of the room, and then two couches. That's all there is.
I still have a migraine, so I'll let you guys decide. I can't think straight right now.
I say we go to the door on the right.
Okay.
Doors have not been favorable.
This one?
I think one of us should know the ship a little bit, right?
Yeah.
So we should take some, like, directional... Like, we know kind of which way the control is.
Well, Justin and I just beamed aboard.
Well, you are the security chief. I feel like that's your job.
Well, we've just beamed aboard, but haven't we been on this ship for a while?
Only in two rooms.
Yeah, but this is my ship, my home, and I know where I'm going.
All right.
So where are we going?
I think. All right, Nate, lead.
To the right.
Like I said, we had to go through
all this. Yes,
up
there. All right, here we go. 15, 18, 11.
Perfect.
The door opens, no problem.
So we make it through the door. No splinters.
No splinters.
And we're all going. No one's staying behind.
No one's staying behind?
Oh. Yeah. Let's stick together for a little bit.
I think we leave that dirty Andorian behind because he trapped.
Hey. Leave your prejudice in your quarters.
Okay, so
I just saved you all.
Yeah, by slapping everyone. So what you see in front of you is a long corridor. Obviously, you guys are in the corridor. It's a small corridor. There's a door on the right, on the far side of the room, and then, of course, there's one right in front of you, and then there's two doors on the left going to two different rooms.
Well, with your knowledge of the ship, which way gets us to the bridge fastest? Do we know?
So I'm gonna add something to you, Nate. So if you're gonna use the home for your this is your home, this is your ship, sort of like value to it. I'm gonna give you an ability of you know the layout. So
yeah,
just say I'm thinking.
I'm thinking.
So
and
the,
I need to go.
No. I mean saying to me, I'm thinking, and then I'll tell you what you're thinking.
Okay, I am thinking.
And those two rooms are just school classrooms.
Okay, so I think we should just keep on going down the hallway. It's no point searching these rooms.
Agreed.
We haven't seen anybody, so should we check survivors or keep going to the con?
I think we need to find out what's going on first. But also, do we need to keep going down the corridors, or is there any way we can go in some Jeffrey's tubes or something to climb up to the bridge? Is that an option?
No,
Jeffrey's tubes were created for this game.
Well, there's none in this area,
okay,
I should say.
All right, that works.
Yeah, there's none in this area. The paneling is all solid up on top.
Well,
I guess you can't really see you can't see the ceiling, so I guess, yeah.
Mm. Okay, let's go straight.
Straight?
Yep.
All right.
Down the hallway.
All right, down the hallway.
Oh. Five or higher.
Oh. 17, 10, and 1.
Uh-oh.
Nate, you got another blister.
What? My hands. My hands.
Yay.
Yay.
Thank you for your sacrifice.
We'll sacrifice one to save the many. I don't care.
Yeah. All right, so you're in the next room.
Okay, and I'm thinking of which way to go.
Well, you maybe shouldn't think. Let's search the room first.
Okay, okay. So we're searching.
This room is actually low-level crew members, so like in lower enlisted crew members. You see right in front of you two bay doors that can open and shut, but both of them are open, and there are four beds in there, and looks like a coffee table and, yeah, and chairs.
It's like living quarters.
Yeah, living quarters. There you go. Thank you.
Well, we should search the rooms for Advil for their migraines. From the.
Thank you.
Or, yeah, some basic medical to fix the splinters.
Band-aid.
Like a pair of tweezers or something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, carbon fiber tweezers.
Okay, so carbon fiber tweezers. So you look around the room and you find your medicine and your tweezers. There you go.
Yes.
And I'm assuming you're applying the heal.
So we heal Nate's boo-boos.
Yes.
And my migraine.
And his migraine.
And also Amy's migraine too.
Oh, yes. From the transporter.
Oh.
Yep.
Yeah. And sorry.
Does that fix migraines and slaps, or do they still feel the slaps?
I'm just trying to forget. That was just
temporary. Well, he is an Andorian, so he only used half his strength. So, Okay. Yeah, he didn't kill them, thankfully. So.
Well, now that we've found medicine, I think we should go through a door. I'll leave it to Nate to choose which one.
Yes.
So you're going through the next door?
Yes.
Okay.
Trying to.
Hopefully you don't get any splinters inside. Which one are you going? Which one are you thinking of going into?
The one that takes us towards control. That one. Okay. Or as I'm thinking, and I should know the ship by now, or since this, I live here.
Or this. Which one?
What's he thinking?
There are three doors.
Yeah, what am I thinking?
You said you have to tell him what he's...
No, it does not work like that. What are you thinking?
It's foggy. I think the gas made me forget a little bit, so I can't quite remember.
The gas that didn't affect you because you weren't in the room?
But it seeped out of the room.
Sounds like an excuse to me, but okay.
Okay.
I say top right room.
This one?
Excellent.
That
yes.
one. Yes.
Good choice.
14, 11, and 9.
Woo!
We're almost through another door.
Yay. And we're all going together.
Okay.
Together.
Oh, gosh.
Back to the classrooms.
Well, more classrooms.
More classrooms. So, obviously, just like the last one, you guys are on the deck where they teach children to read and write. And
this corridor looks familiar. Stuff.
are you leading us in circles, Senior Chief?
I thought we were going one way.
I think there's just a lot of parts of the ship that look similar, but
so we need to get off this deck because it's lower deck, living quarters, and classrooms.
Well, instead of going straight through to more living quarters, let's go to that door on the right.
Is there a door on the right?
Yes.
There is a door on the right. Let me find the tile real quick.
Wait, is there a door on the right, though?
Yes, there is.
Okay.
All right, let's go through that one. I agree.
Hold on, let me find the tile. It's, apparently, I did not mark these really well. Hold on. I'm trying to find it. I'm going as fast as I can. No, that's not it.
Take body breaks, boys and girls.
I know, right?
Yeah, so how is the planet?
It was really
a little it's treacherous. Like a
loading, it's like a loading screen.
Buffering.
I love it.
We didn't buy this DLC content yet, so we gotta wait.
Okay, here we go.
Do we have to roll to get into this room, or are we just like...
Or do we just march through the door?
Yeah, we just bust through.
No, you roll through and you're fine. You're fine.
Yeah.
You rolled a
Okay.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. You rolled a 6, 11, and a 17. So.
Okay, so we're through the door.
So now you're in another long corridor, and this time it's looks like it's the medical bay.
Ooh, sick bay.
Well, we did already. What's it called? We already healed ourselves earlier from the living quarters.
Maybe there's some clues there, or there's a doctor there treating people that might be able to tell us something.
Or maybe communicated with the bridge.
So I'm just going to...
This has also been a treacherous journey already. I say
I'm going to give you guys a freebie. You guys are ignoring the very equipment that's inside your bag right now.
The tricorder?
Tricorder? Do I have a tricorder?
Yeah.
You do have... All of you guys have a tricorder.
Yeah.
I have an engineering one. Should I engineer something with it?
Well, I have a science tricorder so we could scan and see what's in there. Okay. I'm going to scan.
You're going to scan? Okay. So that's going to be... It's a considered... I'm going to consider it as a simple task. So let's go with 10 or higher.
Okay.
10 or higher. I won't fail you. Oh, he already did. Sweet.
Failed her? Or
oh, you rolled. So take your roll.
Okay. So she rolled a 15, 13, and a 7.
Uh-oh.
So the tricorder detects residue of another species aboard the starship. And it only was able to scan 5 feet in front of her.
Oh. So
there is another species in the sick bay. I don't know what it is.
Friendly to the Federation.
It's just unknown to the tribe.
You're going to have to scan again because, like I said, she didn't roll the one that could identify the species, unfortunately.
No, scan again. This might be helpful.
Okay.
7, 19, and 1.
Oh. No, my scanner is not picking up. Does anyone have a different scanner besides a science tricorder?
I have just a regular tricorder.
Nathan, you have a medical one.
Tricorder.
Okay, let's try the engineering tricorder.
Okay, I will use my engineering tricorder. Is it still 5?
10 or higher. 10 or higher.
Higher, okay. 2, 19, and 9. Unsuccessful.
It yields no results.
Man.
Can we go into sick bay and see what's going on in there?
With it. Okay. Well, okay. Well. Look, there's 4 of us that are non-humanoid, so it's probably just another member of the crew. Can I sense that?
No.
Okay.
The dampening
field
is...
Well, we know there's another species.
The dampening field is hindering your distance of your Betazoid powers.
Okay.
Well, then, without knowing the species, let's be careful in case...
Yes.
Phasers
out.
That's one of
my talents.
Break down the door.
I'm cautious.
Nate, you have a medical tricorder. You have a medical tricorder. Just you.
Okay. I don't know how this is going
to
be helpful.
Well, it's you scan.
To know what species.
You scan.
Maybe the dice will be nicer to you.
Do you want me to roll it? Do you want me to roll it? I just rolled it. Okay, so you have 3 20s.
Woohoo!
The species is Romulan.
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 That's not a surprise since we saw some on the planet. Yes?
I know. Okay, what are we going to do with the Romulan on the other side of the door in our sick bay?
No. Residue of a species.
Yeah. Oh, the residue like we found on the planet.
Like blood or?
Just things
just like skin or, skin or something like that. Whatever. Yeah.
I think we should just be cautious with our phasers out, ready for anything from here on out.
Agreed.
Maybe have the security officer lead the way.
All right. Plasma. I'll lead the way with my compression rifle in hand.
Okay. Let's break down some doors.
All right.
I like this.
All right.
Here's
Johnny. I say break down the door.
The door in front of us?
Yeah, which
we
door?
Need to get to sick bay.
Well, we know...
Sick bay or somewhere else?
Okay.
I mean, maybe in sick bay they'd have more information, but it seems like there's a threat aboard and we need to get to the bridge as fast as we can so they don't take over the ship, right?
Exactly. I say we keep going.
Yeah.
You think we found
everything we keep on going.
That we needed to find? Okay.
So were we successful through the door?
Oh, I didn't know what you guys were doing. Which door? Which
door
are you guys going
through?
I say we go straight, right through the corridor.
To the left?
We know there's nothing through these sick bays.
Right, to the left or the front?
Front.
Front. Yeah, front.
I think front.
Front, yeah.
10, 17, and a 4. Nate, why are you the door knocker? Oh, that's right, you're security. Yeah.
And he knows the ship.
He doesn't have to know the ship to break down the door, but okay.
But I am getting a lot of splinters, it sounds like.
No, we healed you.
Well, he...
Well, I just got a 4.
Oh.
Yeah.
Did he just get a boo-boo, not a splinter? Or is it a full splinter?
He bruised his hand. How about that? Oh, okay. There we go. He bruised his hand.
I think we should just try and jimmy doors from now on.
Yeah, don't they have those little contraptions that you put on the door and then slide it open? I've seen them before. On the
so Enterprise. Are you running at it? Are you like opening it, or what are you doing? Are you like what exactly?
So do we not
doing?
Have that device Amy was talking about? You know, the one they affix to the door and it just opens it.
Can we get that equipment in the sick bay? Because Beverly always has.
Oh wait, I have it in my backpack.
Hey, it's look, in the engine. It's Let's use
yeah,
that.
Yeah, it's the 21st century of a crowbar. Yeah.
Yep.
Nate tries to crash right through the door, and it actually forms into a hole, and he falls right through it.
What do you mean a hole? Like there's a hole.
So we're
like
through the door
into the deck and below.
Go to the deck below because he crashed through the door. So there was a hole there.
Yeah,
because
there was a hole there.
Oh man.
So he falls through and he lands on his feet. I'm just gonna give that to you. And so he lands on his feet and he's no problem.
So do we all jump through the hole or just him?
I think we peer through the door and we're like, hey, what's going on down there?
Oh good. We changed decks. That's exactly what I wanted.
Well
Well, I'm downstairs. You guys can jump down with me or
is it safe to jump the distance?
Apparently,
he landed on his
feet. Well, he's Andorian.
I say we all jump through the hole because of the threat of Romulans. We don't want to split up.
Or there might be rope in someone's kit.
Yeah.
I check my kit for rope.
There you go. And he's got rope.
I've got rope.
All right.
So we rope down the hole safely with our Andorian friend.
This ship's taking a lot of damage because of us. Although the hole wasn't because of us, was it? I don't think so.
I mean, you didn't have to blow up the room, but yeah.
Hey, we could have been phasing all the doors.
That hole was definitely there before we got there.
Yeah.
I think
we did cause it.
I think we should take the rope with us just in case.
I grab the rope. So,
there you go. He grabs the rope.
Lose it.
I grab the rope.
All right, I'm switching screens real quick. On trying to find the tile for the next rooms. Because I have a funny feeling you guys are going to go try one of them. Oh, there it is.
Okay, By the way, though, we're on a different deck, but the bridge is above us, so isn't this a step back?
Yeah, we're going farther than we need to.
Yeah.
I mean, you guys jumped down here with me.
Well, we have the rope. Should we climb back up and see what's going on in the deck above us?
No, there's nothing on that deck.
Yeah, but we're...
We could be on our way to engineering, and that's below.
All right.
So you see, So you see right in front.
Let's search the room to see what we're in first.
You see right in front, right in front of you, that there are three doors or four doors. I'm sorry, and you're on the storage deck for computers.
Mm. Oh, I think we should look through the storage stuff.
Do you want to go through that room where the servers are?
To get us restored comms.
Well, maybe with the engineering kit, we can see if we can restore some computer capability. I don't know.
This is just a storage unit, guys.
It's not really where the main computer would be.
Yeah.
Okay, then let's just go through the door in front of us.
Which door?
This door, that door,
the one in front.
The one in front.
This into one? The storage unit?
Is that what you want to do?
Storage unit? No,
yeah,
that's where we're ER. Okay, sorry.
We'll go to the door to the left. There you go.
This,
away from
this
the
one?
Storage unit. Yes, that door.
All right, so here we go.
I think the highest... Okay.
All right, it was successful. No splinters.
Thankfully. All
right.
Doors are giving this much trouble. I don't want to see what happens more.
The room is short, and it opens up to four different doors. And that is a plant.
Are we in, Senior Chief?
That is a plant thing in the corner.
A plant thing?
Oh, I'm sorry. No. It's a couch. I'm sorry.
A couch. Let's all sit down on the couch and rest. We've been through a lot of room. No.
I think we should keep moving forward, see if we can...
Are you thinking, Nate, or are you just telling me?
Think.
Yeah. I would say thinking? I would like to start thinking of where we're at right
okay,
now.
So you are in a on the other side of these on the other side of the door that's over there. It's a briefing room.
Okay. It doesn't seem like a briefing
a waiting room,
room
and a briefing room. This is a briefing room and this is the waiting room.
The waiting room.
And that's just another closet. That's a closet.
I think we should just go down. Because this is just a briefing room. I don't know what we're
going
to find.
But we could find... Remember when we went into the quarters and we saw the video? The personal
there could be
log?
An interrupted brief. I think we should go in the briefing
room. Before we go anywhere, shouldn't we be scanning before we go in the room so that, like, right up to the door, and even if it's 5 feet, we can see if there are any Romulans in there?
Great. Let's scan and then go in and see if there's any logs that we can gain more information about the nebula.
Who's going to scan?
I will scan. Science tricorder me.
Okay, so let's go with insight and engineering. So 10. Wait, is that yours? Yeah, that's yours. Yeah.
Yeah, so
10 or higher. Here we go. 15, 10, 11. You detect... Great. 5 Romulans on the other side of the room.
My intuition was right.
Good job, Justin.
All right. Phasers on down. Stun. Let's stun them all and figure it out later.
Break the door down.
So there's 5 Romulans. Ooh, Romulan figures. Look at that. I'm really impressed.
Yeah, they're not painted, but that's okay.
Time, Richard, but I'm really impressed by all this.
Well,
Yes.
Had to go all out for his last episode.
So there's 5 figures
in there. Go in there and question the Romulans.
Yeah.
We kill all 1.
Not kill, stun them. We're
why not kill?
Because we're not
going to. We don't want them.
They're invading our ship.
We don't want them coming back after they're stunned and coming up behind us.
They're not like, vermin.
What happened, guys? We're not going to kill them.
He's looking it in the eyes of an exterminator.
Well, after aggressive, I don't know how well we're going to take on 5 of them if we're 4 of us.
Well, it'll just be the element of surprise. We'll just stun 4 of them quickly and ask the go ahead.
So what are you guys going to do?
I think we go in element of surprise, stun them, and question 1 to see what their motives are.
Yeah.
Okay. So
who's going to go through the door and how are you guys going to do it? I need a plan of an attack.
I think I should use my engineering kit to go through quietly.
Quietly?
I'll use my
infiltration skills to go through the door.
The room is pretty small, so I don't think you're going to be able to go in there quietly, dude.
I say we bust the door down and then stun as many as we can at once.
I am proficient in hand-to-hand combat, so I can punch my way through.
Yeah, but you can't take a phaser right off the bat.
I'm trying, man.
Their phasers are set to kill.
Okay, bad idea. No punching. Only. I think we got through.
This will be your guys' first combat. So,
for all we know.
Other characters, not bugs or something like that. So,
but
you're
we also
be going
know
against...
where the medical quarters are at. If we need to backtrack, we can.
Get a gurney and friggin' pull your idea. Up.
Well, you know what? Wait, we could do? It looks like there's a couple of doors into that room. Maybe a few of us can go on one side and a few on the other side.
I like
there's
it.
There's only one door.
No, there's two. Move that Romulan out of the way. There's two doors that go in there.
But that goes into the briefing room.
Oh, but we
no,
can't
not
get
this
in
the waiting
there.
Room.
Can't we go up there and back? Oh, you. Oh,
no, that's a closet.
No, door
no that's
there.
Just a closet.
That's a closet. Dang. Yeah, it's a
wait a minute. Could we get that gas seep into the room again, like we did the closet?
Oh,
and knock them out.
Can we use that neosporin?
The neurazine gas. Well, do we have a console where we can activate that?
Let's search the walls for a console.
No, there's no console in the room you guys are in.
Dang it!
Darn it!
Closet console.
I think since we know they might be hostile, I think we should keep a tab of where they're at, and then maybe come back once we have more information.
Or maybe more
weapons. We'll run into some people, and they'll even the odds.
Maybe.
Okay, let's do that.
I say we leave for right now.
Standing in the hallways and solving it.
Man, I thought you guys were going to fight.
Well, we're thinking about it, but you know, it seems likely five.
I was ready to go.
I was like, all right, here we go. Here we go.
I was ready to throw haymakers, but nobody wants to agree with me. So
you are outranked, but you do have more experience, but you are outranked.
And we're outnumbered.
Okay, so I say we leave for now to the down. We
what
go
do you
down.
Mean down.
So you want to go this way?
Oh.
What are we going to dig a hole through the floor?
No, not just the door.
No.
The bottom
18,
door.
18, and 10. So you successfully go through the door.
Success.
Yeah, without any injuries.
So we know. No injuries.
No bruises.
And they didn't hear us breaking
injuries.
Down the doors. So they
there. And they're not following us.
Hopefully.
Cool, another hallway.
All right, Nate, where are we?
I'm distracted by the Romulans. Can you take them off the table? There we go.
Sorry. I dropped one, so I was like, I was trying to find it.
So. Okay, I say we search the room to see what we have.
So we search the room?
We're searching.
So you're searching the room, and there are four couches with four tables in front of them. There is a kind of computer console a door with a computer console on the other side, and those are four Jeffrey tubes.
Oh, Jeffrey's tubes.
Ooh, Jeffrey.
But you know what? Maybe we should see if we can look at the console beyond the door to see if it helps get us more information, and then try to get up the Jeffrey's tubes. Yeah.
I agree.
So open the door?
Yeah, yep. Open the door with the computer console.
Or should we scan it? What are we opening it for?
There's a console behind
it. Just
to get to the console.
Oh, okay. Got it. Open the door.
But we didn't scan the room, so there could be Romulans.
So what do you want to do?
Room. Oh, you mean behind
okay,
it?
Scan.
I say we scan first okay. And then
yes.
Who's scanning who's scanning the room?
I'll scan the room, okay. Or she'll scan.
Who?
So for me to scan, it's insight and engineering. I need a 10 or higher.
Yep, 10 or higher. All right. 18, 1, and 3.
Oh, dear. My scan was unsuccessful.
Yep.
How about I go ahead and scan the room now?
Okay.
So mine is what?
Control and engineering.
So I need a 12.
Uh-oh.
Yep, or higher.
17, 10, and 5. Unsuccessful scan.
Well.
Nate?
Buddy else?
Wait, I guess it's time for you to break down the door.
All right. I just say we break down the door. It seems like it's just a console on the other side.
Will the Romulans hear us from the room over, though?
We could try and jimmy it instead.
Well, let's
like
try to jimmy
it. Like you're stealing a car, or are you using the... The engineering thing to
I think engineering. I'm going to use my toolkit.
All right, there we go. All right, so that's going to be. I'm just going to give it to you for 5. So go ahead and just roll if you 5 or higher.
13, 20, and 18.
Okay, all so right. The door opens successfully.
Make sure we have our phasers out in case there's Romulans.
Well, it's a short, a very, very short room. So. The door opens and you see the console. It's flickering.
Great. Let's engineer it.
Wait, I want to see you try to put the four of us into that room.
Yeah.
Alvin, go
there
in.
We go. We're like on top of the console and the
perfect.
Door.
Well, I can't really get my engineering skills out with all you right on top of me. Two of you should leave so I can scan this.
All right, so I'm assuming you're going to use your toolkit. What are you going to use out of your toolkit?
I'm gonna use.
So you have like a power, like a mini power generator, and also you have some computer. Yeah, you have a mini power generator in there. So if
I'm gonna use my mini power generator to restore power to the panel.
That's gonna be control and engineering.
Okay, so another 12. 13, 3, and 12. Ugh. So it was unsuccessful.
It's a partial.
Partial.
The
partial.
Console shocks the console shocks you, but thankfully you are sturdy. So it only burns and gives you a second degree burn on both your hands. The console is now working and it has full power.
I think you should call someone else in to help with the console cuz your hands are burned.
Yeah. Someone come and lick the console while I lick my wounds.
But don't we have like a medical kit? Don't you have a kit?
You're not a dog, dude.
I do. I have emergency medicine skills.
Right, but it's only for like burns and cuts and all that kind of stuff. So
you just said I have a burn.
I'm just letting you know. Yeah. I'm just letting you know. That's all.
Yeah. So does she try to heal me, or does she leave me burning?
I don't know. That's up to you. Well, second degree burn doesn't. Okay, we'll make it a third degree burn. How about that?
Yeah, let's. Amy, can you treat Alvin?
I'm severely injured. Can you treat me?
Yes.
It's only a second degree burn.
I can do emergency medicine.
All right. So medicine. So it's going to be medicine and control. So 10 or higher. So yeah. All right. There you go. Your hands are healed.
Yay! Okay.
Thank you for healing me after that long conversation.
Great. So what? Now that we have some power, what does the console say?
I don't know. No one's manning it.
Yeah, huh? Alvin is. I just healed.
Oh,
him.
You are now. Oh, Alvin is now. Okay, so
I'm manning the console.
I'm just watching.
He's engineering.
Okay, so I'm assuming you're okay. So
or do I have
so
to say what it's saying?
What are you looking for, Alvin? Are you looking for status? Or are you looking for like some
I'm something? Looking for information on what is going on and why the Romulans are here.
So the console tells Alvin that there are Romulans in the engineering main engineering, and then on the same deck as you guys are on as well, and there are Romulans also on the bridge.
Mm.
Nerosene gas has filled most of the Jeffrey tubes.
Okay, so Jeffrey's tubes aren't good. Is there any way through that console we can access and see if there are any captain's logs or anything that would tell us why the Romulans are here, recordings of anything?
Main computer's down. Main computer's down.
The main computer.
Have the Romulans been able to get any information from the bridge?
No. The computer is locked and main computer is down. That's why they're okay. That's why they're in engineering and also the bridge.
So then, should we go to engineering to stop them from getting our logs, or should we go to the bridge to take over?
We can't with the Jeffrey tubes.
I say we go to engineering to at least stop that.
Do we know, is engineering on this deck, or is it somewhere else?
It is on this deck.
On the engineering deck.
Nate's thinking, yes, it's on this deck.
Yeah. Oh, then let's go to engineering.
Yeah, let's go to engineering.
Okay, Nate, which door do we go through for engineering?
Do you want me to think it for you?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Engineering is in this, is going through this door.
Didn't we already go through that door?
I thought that's where we came from.
No, that was this one.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I say we go towards engineering and phaser's ready.
Phaser's ready. Let's go through.
Oh, wait. Didn't we just say there was Romulan in engineering?
Yeah, so let's scan the door before we go.
Is engineering right beyond the door, or is it further along?
No. The route to it is that's the way to engineering. It's not in engineering.
Okay.
Well, with engineering there, I still think we should scan the door.
I agree. I'm cautious.
See how many. Yeah.
Oh.
Who's scanning the door?
I am. 10 or higher.
I never get to scan anything.
Oh.
So you scan if you want.
What's your number?
What do you got?
It probably should be the lowest person. Yeah.
So what numbers am I looking for?
Yours is 14, so no. Yeah.
And what's mine?
Yeah, get it. I'll just watch.
Your Amy's is 10, and yeah. I'm sorry, not Amy. Yeah, Amy's 10. Alvin is 11.
11.
See,
and Nate is actually 7.
All right. I got it now. Go ahead.
Well, if Nate's 7, why doesn't he scan?
Nate, scan.
No one asked
you. On you, Andorian. We shouldn't. Wait a minute. You're a senior chief. We shouldn't have to ask. You should be assisting us as a team.
Oh.
All right, I'm scanning the door.
All right. There's nothing on the other side. Well, there is something on the other side. It is... Let me get this tile first. Loading screen.
Got a really bad Wi-Fi connection here. I think we should go to the Starbucks.
What? On the other side, on the other side of the room, there is a, it's a room that's empty with two computer consoles inside.
No Romulans?
No Romulans. No life signs.
No crew members. Where the heck are all the crew members?
I know, right?
I think we should go through the door.
By the Nezerpine gas.
I say we go through the door
and check those consoles.
Okay, let's go.
All right, who's doing the busting?
No, we thought we were going to jimmy it. So busting.
I thought we were going to jimmy it so we can.
Are you
going to
jimmy it or are you going to dance?
I'm sprinting at the door already. I'm already. All right.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Fiber hire. Oh my gosh. 17, 17, 17.
Yay.
So he successfully crumbles the wall and door.
I feel really bad for the crew that's going to repair all these doors. Man, we're just wrecking the ship.
Thinking. This direction. To engineering.
I say we go straight for engineering.
Well, hold on a second. Okay, so you guys go into a cross
We're
cross
looking
door.
Around the room. Where are we?
Yep, there's a monitor here on the other side of that door. There's a monitor to there. Jeffrey tube, and that is an access panel to outside the ship.
Outside the ship, okay. Well, we don't want to end it this way.
I think we might want to go directly for engineering to stop the Romulan threat.
Yes.
Okay.
You don't want to see what's on the console panel?
Well, if we go to engineering, we might be able to get power back. And also to clear the Jeffrey tubes of gas.
Yep, makes sense.
So what you want to do? You want to go through the door?
Yeah, we're going through the door. Scan the door first. Scan the door first. 7 or higher.
Who's doing the scanning? Nate?
Me.
Nate is.
18, 15, and 5. So it was a partial. There are 5 objects inside the room. In the next room. It is the shuttle bay.
I say we have phasers on the ready. We keep going.
Yeah. It says objects, not life forms.
It doesn't say life forms, and it's the shuttle bay.
You know what? The shuttle bay could be really helpful because maybe we could pilot a shuttle outside the ship and then be able to transport into engineering or wherever we want to from the shuttle transporter.
That is a good idea. I concur.
Just make sure you put your seatbelt on, okay?
Yeah. Somebody forgot.
So let's see if we jimmy this door.
So is Nate Nate going through the door again?
Yep.
Yep.
So you're running through it?
Chalking off.
Oh, 6, 10, and 3.
He bounces backwards?
Yeah, he bounces backwards. Off. Yep, he bounces backwards. It's a shuttle bay door, so it's able to handle decompression. So, yeah.
Let's get out that phaser.
Okay. Yeah. Well, now that he's knocked out, I think I should use one of my engines.
No, he's not knocked out.
Okay.
He just suffered a really bad headache, that's all.
So should we have him run at the door again?
I mean, apparently headaches running this ship all the time, so.
Yeah.
You know.
All right, I say Alvin opens the door with his engineering kit.
Although, what other tools do I have? Because I think I only have one kit left. We might need it for engineering.
So,
What tools are in my bag?
Yes, there are lots of tools. You have a power generator, you have rope, you have one of those thingy bobbers that look like...
Let me use the thingy bobber.
Is that a self-sealing stem bolt?
No.
I would like to use the thingy bobber to open the door, please.
Okay, so that's going to be control and engineering. So that's 12. Wait, 12? Yeah, 12, yeah.
Okay, guys, I got this thingy bobber. I got a 13, 14, and 20.
Woohoo!
Okay, so the door opens. Woohoo!
Oh, we have our phasers, though.
We have our phasers. What's
there's five objects. What do we see?
Please be four ships.
Five shuttlecraft, yes.
And we did scan to check, like, we're not going to be blown out the door, right? Into space. Wow, that looks
we all just die.
would hope
there's nothing in the room, or at least in this section of the shuttle bay.
Man, how many of these did you make? This is crazy.
I didn't make any of these. Oh. These are all pre-made. Yeah, these are all pre-made.
Okay, you made the figures. Okay.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
So how far in front of us can we see? Can we just walk all
so
the way to
right
the
in front top? Of you, you see the you see that shuttlecraft and that engineering pod as well. Clink, mm-hmm. clink, 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 clink. Something's coming towards you.
Clink. Phasers at the ready.
Phasers at ready.
Phasers are ready. I got my compression rifle out.
Oh, okay.
And all of a sudden, you guys see coming out of the coming out from the other side of the room.
What is that?
It's an octopus. It's called an octopus. Apparatus of octopus. It's a D&D piece, but I'm gonna turn it into a monster. So.
Oh my God! Stun it.
And it's staring right at you guys. What do you guys do?
I think Nate should shoot it because it is definitely hostile.
Well,
we need to kill.
Wait, but. We don't know if it maybe.
How do we
can
know it's hostile?
Tell us something. Can we try talking to it?
Yeah, sure. Let me.
You want to kill everything?
If it's friendly.
This is Star Trek. We don't
okay.
kill everything.
I ask if it's friendly.
Okay, so
is that, yeah. that would be command and control, wouldn't it?
Well, you can't do two disciplinaries. You have to do an attribute and also discipline.
One of my attributes is control, though.
Yeah.
Oh, was it? Oh, I'm sorry. Oh,
yeah.
That's
yeah. So I would guess I would use command and control, which is
well,
12.
Well, wait a second. I mean, who has the? I know someone has the diplomacy.
I think.
Oh, I do.
Oh.
He's like,
stop
oh.
letting me stop letting me try to kill everything and let's get panicking.
Wait, before we shoot, let's ask questions. Let me approach it because you
Are
know
you sensing
I'm
anything?
Sensing. I'm sensing I might be successful.
No. Yeah. All right, Amy. All right. So if you're going to do it, then it's going to be, control and command. So 13.
Oh, shoot. 13.
Right. Are you rolling for her or am I?
I will.
You can roll for her. Oh, or it doesn't matter. Whichever one.
Okay. I will not fail you, Amy.
Okay.
14, 15, and 7. So
oh, I'm partially.
So what are you saying to the apparatus or whatever, or the octopus?
What am I saying, guys? Help me out.
Are you here to kill us?
Hi, can we help you?
Say, so what is your purpose here? Why are you on our ship?
No response.
Maybe the other diplomat.
No, I need a
you need a partial response. So the right arm starts to bring up and looks like it's gonna whip you. It's up in the air right now, and
guys,
how far away is it?
Help me out.
My original plan. I say Nate shoots the arm. It's got other ones. It'll be okay.
Arm is about to strike.
But how do we know it's not trying to show us something or tell us something, or it doesn't communicate through gestures?
Somebody shoot the arm, please.
I don't want to die.
So right. What are you gonna do, Amy? You're the one that's in front.
God,
I'm gonna scan it.
Okay, right. Okay, so that's gonna be engineering and control. So 10 or higher.
10?
10.
All right, I'll roll for it. 17, 16, and 19.
Okay, it's success scan. Tell me everything about it.
You detect you detect two Romulans inside with hostile intent.
Okay.
All right, let's stun it now.
And
let's shoot that arm.
Here we go.
It's about to whip.
Now
her.
It's my turn. So I got to do I made it for 15 or higher, so to attack. So, there we go.
Jeez.
11, 4, and 16.
Okay.
So it grazes her?
So the yes, exactly. The arm comes across and gives Amy a nice swipe in the cheek. Or not a cheek, but like a cut on the cheek.
This is a painful
mission. Now you have a cut in your cheek.
Okay.
So I think it's time we shoot this thing.
I shoot.
And as I get smacked and I'm falling down, attack! Thank you.
Because she's on the ground. She's on the ground because she got slapped. She got slapped, scratched, I guess.
All right, so what do we need for a successful attack?
So for an attack, it's going to be control and security. So it's going to be a lot less. So it's going to be 11 for Amy.
Yes.
-12.
12 for Alvin, 7 for Nate, and 12 for...
Well, then let's have Nate attack first.
Yeah. Well, yeah, he's also the security chief. Yeah, with my compression rifle. So, all right, go ahead, Nate.
Yeah, with the...
12 or higher.
Yeah. I also have my compression rifle.
Where is my other die? Oh, there it is. Okay, go ahead. Do you have die, right? No?
No.
Okay. I thought okay, Nate did. Yeah.
No.
Uh-oh. 9, 7, 11. Wait.
Have it was 7 or above.
Oh, so. Well, yeah, I'm sorry.
His
yeah.
was so 7 or above, so
that's a triple.
Successful.
I'm sorry. Okay, and then you hit it, you stun the apparatus.
With the apparatus stunned, can we pull the Romulans out now?
No, it's right now on the ground. It's my turn, so if I do a successful, then it'll come back up. If not, then it's you defeated it.
Good job, Nate.
First time around. I get a success, 20, and a 6. The apparatus comes back alive, and its legs are operational, but its right tentacle is the only one that's damaged.
Well, then I'll attempt to shoot the other leg.
Is that what you want to do?
I agree. Yeah,
that's what I want to do. Yes,
so
I want to shoot.
Turn. Okay.
What do I have to roll? 12.
Control. Yeah, 12. Yep.
Oh, I dropped one. 19, 12, and 1. So it's a semi-successful shot?
Yes, it is. You singed off its right leg. One of its right leg. So now it's limping.
Okay, Gimpy, what are you going to do?
Okay. Now it's my turn. 17, 17, 5. Oh! I burned part of your leg, Alvin, your left leg.
Oh, throw me on the ground then.
But you have sturdy, so it's a second degree burn.
Oh, God. All right.
There you go.
Take a crack at it.
Yep, there you go. Yeah, you're next. You're the only one besides Amy, and Amy's going to go come up soon.
Yep.
Okay, so...
I think he needs a 12.
Yes, he does need a 12, yep.
Should I roll for him or you?
I've got dice over here, but...
okay. Well, don't you roll?
Do I need 2 or 3, though?
3.
3.
I may need to get another one. Hold on.
That's fine. I can do it. I can roll one. That's fine. Go ahead.
Oh, he's going to go get it.
Oh,
it
okay. Like... Okay.
So, guys, do you see many of these robots where you're from?
This is the first time I've seen Romulans dressed up in a octopus suit.
All right, now that
we're creating
you've all planned
cannon.
To throw me under the bus, I've got my 3 here.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going for
creating
what, 12
cannon
or higher?
Mm-hmm. Yes, 12 or higher.
All right, all right. 19, 15, 1.
Ah.
You singed off its left hand. So now it can't even attack you guys.
Okay, good.
So now it can't attack you guys. So now it's my turn. See if I can repair. I'm going to try to repair it, the arm. Ugh. 12, 7, 7. Nothing happens.
All right.
Take another
so
shot.
It's so that. Well, actually, it's Amy's turn now, but the apparatus is limping around and it can't attack you.
Okay.
So I get back up.
Okay.
Put me back up. Thank you.
There we go.
All right, so I need an 11 or higher, and I'm.
Are you
going to
attack it?
Yes. Well, wait.
Okay.
No, I'm going to be diplomatic. Now that it's yes, the threat is taken away. We're going
to
talk again, and I'm going to be successful.
Romulans, we know you're in there.
Yeah.
So
I'm going to do. Can I do reason? And command? Ooh,
yep.
That's 13.
13, yep.
Okay.
You can. 15, 14, 11.
Okay, so I reasoned a little bit.
So the apparatus is still not moving, and it looks like someone's trying to get out. That's it.
I say we train our weapons toward it.
And let me do the apparatus first.
I say we stun it.
No, we need the Romulans to come out and tell us what's going on.
Yeah.
No, I was just saying at the ready.
Well, aren't there two of them? Yeah. We could stun one, and then once he sees what happened to his buddy, he gives up?
Maybe, but maybe the one you stun has more information.
So
I say we just point our guns at them and tell make them tell us what they're.
Can we take the apparatus off?
Yeah, can I remove? It's my turn, isn't it?
So they're inside the apparatus.
Okay.
Like that. So. Mm-hmm.
Okay, if it's my turn, I open the door.
What door?
You want to jimmy it open, or are you gonna?
I want to open the door. I want to get the Romulan out.
Oh, okay.
Oh, they've all got their the guns apparatus. At the
ready, so I'm gonna go and.
Well, it's Amy's turn, so
I thought it was.
Oh, okay.
You're on the ground with a burnt leg because.
I thought her turn was over.
Amy hasn't healed you yet.
Oh well, okay, so. The Romulans aren't attacking. I need to heal people so that they can we can back whoever's going to take off the apparatus. So, can I do that now? Mm-hmm. With my emergency medicine?
I said 10, didn't I? Did I say 10?
Yeah, I think so.
20, 15, 19. So, you heal Alvin's leg burn. Okay. So, now he's back up. So
okay.
Now you can do your thing now, Alvin.
Okay, with them that they're ready, I want to go remove the door because I have hand-to-hand combat. So if anything goes wrong, I can punch them.
It's been waiting for that.
So what do I
I love the rationale. I love it.
Hey.
Okay, so
that would be what? Control and security?
Yeah.
Well, I was going to say engineering, but it doesn't matter which one. Yeah.
Let's, I mean, let's do the same thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Alrighty, so I need to roll 12. 18, 15, and 17.
Yay!
The door, Alvin goes over there and rips the door off. Smoke billows out of the apparatus, and you see two passed out Romulans inside.
Man, they're passed out.
Can we slap them?
I was going to say, should we start slapping?
Oh my gosh.
Hey,
that's
I will be perfect,
Nate.
You mean like, can I come back in 30 seconds?
Yeah.
I'll be barking. Sorry, I don't want to bark too much. Sorry.
No, you're good. Slap up.
All right, so they're unconscious, but we need them to get awake, or at least one of them.
Wait, but what about my idea of taking the shuttlecraft and trying to go out, or can we go in the shuttle and use a transporter to go to the bridge or engineering or somewhere we need to go?
Can we?
I think we need more information first.
I think so too.
I slap one awake.
Yes.
Okay.
The slapping hand is ready.
The slapping hand.
Wow.
That's funny,
What did we say that was?
You're daring.
I don't know. There's a number for slapping.
Daring and security.
See, now you guys are making up stuff, and I gotta make this up as on the fly now.
Okay, I'm back.
I'm trying to get us outside of the ship, so you have to make up what it looks like outside the ship.
Okay? Exactly. Now I do.
Wait, did we? Did we slap him awake, or what did we do?
No, we haven't done anything yet. We were deciding on whether or not to.
We're slapping.
Slap.
Roll.
So much violence.
Right. We need information.
All right, so let's go with no. That's right. We said daring and command
security.
Because it was
command.
A daring.
Oh,
so that's
okay.
six or higher.
Ooh.
8, 1, and 2.
Oh man!
Wow! My slap just didn't do anything.
Because of the
splinters.
that was the only one.
Yeah, it's all because of all the splinters.
Okay.
Yeah. There you go. Carbon fiber splinter.
I slapped the second one.
16, 5, and 7. So you slapped the Romulan, but you slapped him too hard, and now he has a concussion, and he's awake, but incoherent.
Great, thanks.
Can you stop slapping Romulans, man, please?
Whoa, what are you doing? Like he's drunk?
Well, if he's incoherent, I think we should at least put him in cuffs. So that he does not
try to.
Do we have cuffs?
You have zip ties in. Yeah, you have zip ties in there. So
I have rope. Remember, we pulled it back out.
Yeah,
well,
but you might need that to climb to another deck.
We're not going to need too much. Don't worry.
Oh, okay. If you're gonna hog tie him, you're gonna use the whole entire thing.
Okay, I'm only going to tie his hands. What do I use for that?
All right, that's half of it. So that means you can only like go partially down on the deck if you ever run into something like that. So you have...
Wait a minute.
I'm not being crazy.
How do we know these two Romulans didn't communicate something to the other Romulans? Is there anything that we can find out about if they sent a communication?
Why don't we scan their ship because now we have access to it?
The octopus thing?
Yeah. Scan the octopus. Maybe we can use it.
So who's doing the scanning?
I will. 7 or higher.
Oh, wait. You have a medical one. So
he has a medical one. It should be me. I'm the engineer.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay. Yeah, but his number's lower.
But his information won't be as good.
But it's all medical, so it wouldn't show up as anything.
Alrighty guys, I need a 12. Here we go.
Okay.
19, 14, and 13.
Yay.
So your scan was able to penetrate the hull of the apparatus of octopus or whatever you want to call it. And you find that yes, they have been alerted in engineering and also the bridge.
Shoot, there's Romulans on the bridge?
Yes, yeah. There's Romulans on the bridge.
We've been trying to go to engineering.
Yeah.
To restore power.
Well, whose turn is it?
Now
the status of the attack right now is that they are still unsuccessful to
I still want to take the shuttlecraft outside of the ship so we can see what's going on. And then maybe we can transport over from those transporters to engineering or the bridge or, I don't know, destroy the bridge. No,
I concur, but we should take a Romulan prison with us.
Maybe we should take both of them.
What?
In the shuttlecraft.
We take a Romulan prisoner with us in the shuttlecraft so they won't shoot us out of the sky.
I so did not plan for this.
Sorry.
I planned for a lot of things. I didn't even think about it in the shuttlecraft.
Justin's plane is the way to go.
You put a shuttlecraft there. Of course I'm going to try to use it.
That's true. That's true. Okay. All right.
So
well,
what does he need to roll to be successful in the shuttle?
Okay. Well,
we need to get in the shuttle, make sure it powers up, and then make sure the door's open from the bay, right?
Okay,
I have a feeling because Richard didn't plan for this, he's going to make it unsuccessful, though.
I know. So let's try and do
no,
something.
No,
different.
By all means. I mean, if you guys want to do that, I'm just going to let you know that it's going to be on the fly now. trying to find
on
tiles
the fly
now.
Is great.
Well, let's go in the shuttle then.
Yeah. So do we
I will make the story as interesting and non.
So what do we have to roll to open shuttle doors? Is it still 5 or is it
well,
four?
We need to make sure we can get in, the doors open to the shuttle and that we can power it up.
That's what I was just saying. We need to. What do we have to roll to open the shuttle doors?
Okay, so that's going to be some science and engineering, or
give me 1 second. Give me 1 second. I'm trying to find the correct.
Richard's making it up right now.
he's freaking out over there.
Yeah, here we go. Yeah. So okay, so it's going to be in order to okay.
She said she'll be right back. So maybe
I saw.
More time. Create more tiles.
Yeah, because I could just.
I expect you to grab that shuttle out of that thing and just.
Hey, get that Enterprise toy you bought the other day. We'll use that as our shuttle.
Oh my god!
You mean this one?
Yeah, and you can just have our four figures like hovering around and floating in space.
I don't think I have something I can use for a shuttle.
It's weird. I have something here for a shuttle, but I'm too far away.
Hey, buddy. Hey.
Hold on.
I do have an add-on on my PlayStation. We could use that. Right.
We'll use the ghost.
We're in the ghost.
Not yet. I mean, we'll wait until she gets back. But like I'm saying, I'll use that as a shuttlecraft.
It's a TOS shuttle, but you know. Can just
it works.
You can say, I have.
It's actually a salt shaker.
Hey, we could go in my AT-AT here. Look at that.
What is that?
We take this. It's an AT-AT or ATST. Got guns and everything. We'll be safe. Now
wrong
we can
franchise.
Kill some Romulans.
Wrong franchise.
I also have the Millennium Falcon here. If we want to take that,
the game would completely break down at that point.
Does not compute. Oh man! Now I can see why Dungeon Masters friggin' get stressed out.
I'm sorry, but it's the most logical thing.
No, it's fine. No, that's fine. I was trying to plan for as many outcomes as I could, and that was one I did not even think about. So,
just know that there's a possible outcome where we set the self-destruct. I hope you have planned for that.
Oh man! Well, there's no adventure after that. Then I guess.
Well,
hey, go ahead.
So far, there's only four of us. There's four of us in a hostile force trying to take our computers. We could kill ourselves to save the fleet. Same
could happen. Could. He's like, no, don't make that happen.
I am on board.
Great.
He's gonna bring back Miguel for the next one. He didn't really die.
Oh,
maybe,
man.
Q's brought back Miguel and he is coordinating the Romulans as his revenge.
Richard's currently deleting all our phone numbers and getting rid of his friends.
Well, I can't get rid of one of them. I mean, he is my brother.
Hey.
You said that like, wait a minute, you can get rid of me.
I know, right?
So, Amy, I found a shuttle, although it's a TOS shuttle.
Oh, nice.
So we're going to use this little ghost figure I have that's tiny, as since the venture is so small, so, you know.
We'll that'll be our shuttle. Cool.
Yeah.
If we can make it out.
All right. So we're getting onto the shuttle.
We have to roll to open the doors.
Which doors are you
The
are you
shuttle door. Can we get in the
in
shuttle?
In the shuttle. We want to start with the shuttle.
Okay. So we said doors 10 or higher. Nate, if I'm assuming you're the door breaker, or do you want someone else to open it?
I don't
want
the doors.
We don't want to break the doors on the shuttle.
No, we can't do that.
Get sucked in.
Why don't I use
open them?
Why don't I use my generator to restore power to it?
Why does the shuttle have no power?
We don't know. We just need to go up and see if the door opens, right?
Well, first you gotta scan it.
Let's open the door.
Okay, then you could open the door too.
Okay, but what are the two things for the door?
Who's doing it first off? It's
I
gonna
don't
be
know. It
let's,
on what numbers I have.
I mean, I'm the engineer. I'll open it.
Let's just do reasons and engineering. So
I have
12.
Okay,
it's
so 12
for me.
14. Okay, you have 10, Amy.
I'm the 12.
Yeah.
So who's doing it?
I'm opening. Unsuccessfully, 10, 7, and 4.
Okay.
Engineering and reason. I have a 3 and a 2.
Well, then why didn't we have him?
Yes.
Well, he's going to break the door open.
He's not going to break the door open. Not
if we get a successful roll, he won't. So who's going to roll for him?
All right, I'll roll for him, yeah. What was it?
Maybe I should roll for him so you don't sabotage us.
I'm not sabotaging you guys. I've actually been very generous on giving you guys some things.
Yeah, you haven't killed me yet like you did last time.
Yeah, I haven't killed anyone yet. I almost killed you, Nate.
All right, go ahead and roll.
Breaking down the doors.
Anybody? Anybody going to roll?
I thought Richard was.
Sorry, I had a dice to go underneath the table.
I thought Richard was rolling too.
Okay, so who's rolling? All right, so it's a 7?
Oh, yeah. 5. I thought it was 5. Yeah.
5.
Oh, was it 5? Okay, 3 and 2. I'm sorry. 18, 8, and 13. The door of the shuttle opens up and is not damaged.
Excellent.
The lights don't come on.
No power
inside the shuttlecraft.
Yeah, but Alvin has his little power generator.
Right? I wanna hook my generator to the computer to run a diagnostic on the shuttle to see what's going on.
Okay, then that's gonna be.
By the way, does someone have custody of these Romulans and making sure they aren't like waking up and doing stuff?
I thought we tied them up.
We tied them up.
They were tied up. Right. We're out of rope because I tied both of them.
Yeah,
we're gonna try to take them in the shuttle if the shuttle works right.
Yes, okay. So what do I have to roll? It'd be control and engineering, right?
Yep, control and engineering, 12.
12. Ooh, 1, 15, and 18, so I partially restore power?
Yep. The power, so the the shuttlecraft's power comes back on, but it's minimal power. You cannot go to warp with this shuttlecraft. Actually, it only has maneuvering thrusters, and that's it.
That might be okay for going around the ship, but does it also have weapons power?
It does not.
Dang. Does it have power for the transporter?
It does.
It does. Maneuvering thrusters and transporter.
I say we take the ship. It's got thrusters. It's got the transporter.
We don't need to go anywhere. All we need to do is activate the transporter and transport over to engineering.
Well, there is that.
I don't want to be a sitting duck out there. And if we transport into engineering with phasers ready, they will be surprised and we have the element of
surprise. Okay, but here's the question. Does it have enough transporter power to transport four of us?
No. It only has power.
What if I hook my generator up to it?
You did do it. I'm sorry. You didn't do it. That's right.
I did. I hooked it to the ship.
He found an extra power generator in his backpack.
Yeah. I brought some Duracell batteries with me.
There's only enough power to transport three.
Three?
Yep. Simultaneously, okay, and that's behind. It.
I don't know. I'll volunteer to stay behind I haven't been doing much anyway.
I say we stick together because this is not going to go well for us.
I say we do it. We need to stop the Romulans, and we're still on the same floor. One person stays with the two captives. Three go to engineering to stop them, and then we meet back up in the shuttle bay. I'm okay with it.
Why don't you scan first?
I think we need to get to engineering, but
this is the quickest way, and we got to remember they're still trying to hack our.
But we don't know
why
how many
don't
are
you
in
scan?
Right?
Why don't
yeah,
you
do
scan?
We know no how idea. Many? Did he say that before?
Why don't you scan with the shuttlecraft?
Oh, we can use the shuttle to scan engineering, see what's there.
Yep.
Oh, will that take out more power from the transporter where we can only get two, not three?
Nope. The transporter will take out the whole entire generator, but scanning it won't. So you'll still be able to do three.
Okay, let's scan.
So we're just scanning engineering. Yeah.
Oh wait. Who's doing it? I'm sorry. Who's scanning the engineering bay?
It should probably be me scanning because I'll get the most information.
Yeah, he's the engineer.
Oh, okay. His will be information on how to slap people.
So let's go with con and insight.
Okay.
So that's 11 20, for you.
17 and 15.
What? No, you can't have two attributes.
Insight and con?
Oh.
Not control, con. Sorry. Yeah.
Okay, well, I'll re-roll.
No, you got it, right?
No, he already got it.
Yeah, twice.
Yeah, he got it.
I got 17, 16, and 18 on this roll. So
okay. Two scans.
You detect. You have two scans.
So tell us everything.
You detect that only two Romulans in engineering.
All right.
Okay.
Wait,
I think it
before,
should be.
Before,
and they
wait,
still
wait, wait,
there.
Wait,
still...
wait, wait. Before we go anywhere, since we have this power to scan, should we scan again for the bridge and see what's going on there as well? Could that help give us some more information?
I'm okay with doing that. I think we should because we still have the power.
Yep.
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay. I will scan the bridge. 11, 16, and 9, so it's partial.
You detect five bodies.
Five on the bridge.
Five Romulan bodies or just bodies?
Five bodies. He just said bodies.
Bodies. He can't detect the species.
I think we transport two people to the engineering room to take out the Romulans and two to stay with the captors. Anybody?
I think it should be Alvin and I going to engineering so we can use his
engineering
skills.
He's security, and we've already taken out the threat here.
You don't think you need three people there?
Well, he's security, so he's got to be a lower role.
I'll just bust them all down anyway.
I concur with Nate. Anybody else?
What
do you?
Yeah.
Go.
So what do we have to roll for the transport, or do we just get transported?
Yeah, because you might get a headache.
Here's the thing, though. So we're transporting you guys over. There's no communication, so we won't be able to find out what's going on. Should we set it to automatically? No, we don't have enough to transport you back. Okay. Just have to hope for the best.
So wait. So who's doing the transporting? Because you can't do it. Wait. No. Yeah, you can. Because you can do like a. Yeah. Who's controlling the transporter?
Oh, I will.
What is it going to be?
So it's Alvin. So my understanding is Nate and Alvin are going to go over, and someone's going
to
be in the.
Oh, so one of them has to control it.
Yeah.
Okay. So control and engineering. So whichever is the lowest one.
I'm 10.
Are you 10?
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. I was joking.
Justin?
What about you, Justin?
14.
So
see, I'm taking
the Amy's control. Controlling.
10, 10, and 10.
I feel like I'm not of much use in this game. You guys are doing all this stuff.
Well, you can break down doors if you want. You can be the door breaker.
Well, send us to the engineering bay.
All right.
Yeah.
And our phasers are at the ready, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. So.
Ooh.
Oh God, where do you guys want to transport?
Behind
both behind of them. Behind. I mean, come on now.
All right, you guys have materialized right behind them, and they know you're there. What do you do? So now it's just Nate and Alvin right now.
Okay, I'm gonna roll. What do I have to roll for a stun?
You're gonna have to control it, and then let's do security.
Okay, so 12.
Yep. And then Nate, you're gonna have to do the same thing too.
Okay.
I got 8, 14, and 15.
Nate, you got a 7. Wait, what was it again?
I need 12. I got 8, 14, and 15. So wouldn't it be semi-successful?
Yep.
You singed his right hand.
Is that the hand holding the weapon?
Yeah, the only hand holding the weapon. And Nate, you knocked out your guy. So now it's my turn. Okay. With Alvin's dude.
With no weapon. Don't forget that.
He misses.
Alvin, your turn. I'd like to use my hand-to-hand combat now.
No, phaser him again.
You're stunning him, right?
Yeah. Okay. Stun him again.
You don't know what's going on in this room at this
That's
point.
That's right. Yeah. You don't know what's going on.
But one of my focuses is hand-to-hand combat. So wouldn't that work too?
Yeah.
I'm trying to go diplomatic and not kill the guy.
Go ahead.
16, 5, and 19. Do I send his other hand?
Nope. Hold on.
What happens?
You send his left leg, but now he's basically on the floor.
So we win. I think we should interrogate him.
Yes.
Again, you don't know what's going on over there.
I still think they should interrogate him.
Senior Chief, would you like to interrogate them?
Yes. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's do reason and command. So 6 for you.
6.
2014-15, yeah. So you were successful in interrogating him. He tells you that they're an outside faction of the Romulan Empire, and they are here to take over the USS Venture for their personal gain. Their commander is on the bridge with his top lieutenants.
They were
unsuccessful in restoring power to anything on the ship.
Well, since we're engineering, I want to scan the computers to see what other information we can find. Maybe get some doors working so we can make it back to the shuttle bay quickly. I think that's a fair shot there. We're in engineering, so. Control and engineering. Okay.
Yeah.
I got a 14, 15, and a 6.
You were able to scan, or I'm sorry, you were able to, wait, what are you doing?
I'm trying to restore power to some of the doors to get back to the shuttle bay.
The doors will now open, and Nate no longer needs to charge right through them. You have restored communication to those who have comm badges only.
She sent a message to our friend.
Let us know what's going on.
I say we let Amy and Justin know that we have dispatched and we have a Romulan under our interrogating.
I agree. Why don't you just tell them?
Hey,
you just did. You just did. You just did. Yeah. You just told Amy and Justin that you guys have taken over the engineering, the main engineering, and that communication has been restored for anyone that has a comm badge.
What should we do next?
And that, and oh, right, and all doors that can now open without being broken into.
That is great job, you guys. Excellent. I think, can you contain those Romulans in engineering so they don't follow us?
Well, I have no more rope, so it might be to kill them.
Is there anything in engineering? We don't need them coming after us. We've already got the ones in the shuttle taken care of.
Let's search the engineering room.
Okay, so you see two consoles where one an incapacitated or knocked out Romulan is right in front of Nate. In front of Alvin is the distraught and incoherent Romulan who doesn't appear to be any use to anyone. So, and then there are two consoles that are fully operational, or at least lit, that is. And it looks like the warp core is not fully functional yet.
So we don't find anything to tie him up.
So I know you guys never seen Star Trek, or not never seen. You probably don't know what, but the I know, right? But you know what I mean. Like, it's not pulsating like it usually does. It's just.
But they can just stun them and they'll be out for a couple hours, right?
I was just gonna say, why don't we just knock him out?
Okay, you can knock him out if you want. All right, he's knocked out.
Thank you.
So, what are you gonna do with the Romulan when he wakes up?
I think
there's a closet in this room. Why don't we lock him in there? Aren't those closets?
Yep, there are closets. Doors open now.
I agree.
Classic move.
Well, should we search the closet first to make sure there's no weapons they can
use?
There's
nothing in there. There's nothing in there. It's just like
okay. Let's lock him in the closet.
All right, there you go. You're in the closet.
All right.
I'll let them
all right, and I think since all the doors can open and close freely, I think Justin and Amy should join us.
Well, wait a minute. They don't know the ship. Remember, they've only been aboard a few hours.
Is it possible? Wait, I have to ask. We seem to have engineering under control, but we need control on the bridge. Do we have a panel where we can do a site-to-site transport over to the bridge?
But remember, there's only one... Well, wait. Now we're in the transporter, so is it working?
Well, you're an engineer.
You're in the main engineering.
No, Nate is going to guide us with the comm badge, and we're going to come to engineering to get us all together.
Why? Don't we need to go to the bridge?
Well, yeah.
We need to meet back up, though.
But we all need to be together.
Yeah, but we can all transport over there. Can't we just tell the computer to do a site-to-site transport over to the bridge? No.
Not without.
I thought there's not enough power for that.
Not without power.
Okay, so we have enough power to open the doors, but not to transports within the ship. You're saying?
Yes.
Yes.
So I think Nate should guide them here because their Romulans are tied up. We can leave them in the shuttle.
Yep, our Romulans are secure.
I still want to go outside in the shuttle, but okay.
Well, the good news is you have your pilot right there.
So Nate, begin to guide them back, Nate.
Oh, man, you guys are killing me here. You guys are killing me here.
I just built a hole outside of the ship.
Hold on. Okay, so all right, blah blah blah. All right, so Nate successfully. Well, actually, you know what? We got to roll for that. So, all right, so Nate, it's gonna be.
Wait, we got to roll for him to tell us how to get there. Doesn't he know the ship?
Yes.
I thought you already knew the ship. And the doors are working.
Well, let's see if he does it successfully. If he doesn't, then, you know, Amy and Justin hit their head or something like that. I don't know.
Were they in their own room?
Hit our head on the door that's taller than we are?
That's right. That's right.
All right. It's weird.
I gotta give you guys some kind of injury if it doesn't work. So control and command. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Okay, so Nate successfully guides Amy and Justin to engineering.
All right.
Hey, fancy seeing you guys here. We weren't expecting you.
Yeah, great to see you guys. Man, this has been an exhausting mission. I'm going to get a lot of sleep after this. How about you?
Right.
Only if we can secure all the Romulans and get possession of our ship.
What about those other five Romulans we passed by? What happened with them?
Yeah.
I hope they're not right behind us. Oh, well.
They weren't in any sensitive areas.
But there was a warning sent out, so we might want to be careful in case the Romulans attack.
Yeah. Okay.
I think we should try and flush the gas out so we can use the tubes.
Jeffrey tubes. But there's no Jeffrey tubes here.
But where is the rest of the crew? Shouldn't we have seen other people passed out in different rooms? No? This is all very mysterious.
I think we should see what we can do in engineering as far as the clearing the Jeffrey tubes and maybe even possibly directing the gas into
that room
control.
Where there were the five Romulans.
Well, then I would like to use my tricoder to scan the room to see what's working in here.
Which room are you talking about?
Like it.
The room we're in now.
Engineering. Oh, yeah. I thought we knocked out the two already.
Yeah, you don't. No.
Yeah, we already scanned this room.
Oh, I thought I could scan it to make sure.
Yuri scanned the room. So, I mean, really, all there is the Romulans are inside the closet. The computer consoles are lit up, and the main power doesn't look like it's on.
Well, then I search the console to see what I can find off of it.
Okay. Okay.
So, that's engineering and control, right?
Let's go with insight and con.
Okay.
So, 11.
11. 18, 14, and 5. So I partially scan.
No. You weren't scanning, right? You were fixing or you were scanning?
Well, I thought you said the console's lit up, so it should be working.
Okay, yeah. So
wouldn't I find partial
main
power?
Partial main power is back on.
What information did we get from it?
Partial main power is back on. Transporters is now back on. And
woohoo, let's transport to the bridge. Sorry.
And scanning abilities is also
what information?
Well.
I thought we were going for information.
We need to secure the bridge, don't we? We've got the information that the Romulans are here for their personal gain, and we just need to locked down engineering, we need to lock down the bridge, right?
I say we fight. I'm ready to fight.
I'm good. We want to scan over.
Besides the five guys in the room somewhere else, we don't even know where the other Romulans are. There are just some bodies on the bridge. Should we try to get a better scan of the bridge? Because all we know is five bodies.
I was going
to
say, can I use the ship's computers to scan for friendly life forms, not just Romulans, to see where our crew is?
That might be helpful.
Oh, he has to go to the bathroom. I think we scan to look for other life forms so we can create a...
Yeah, you guys discuss. I'll be right back.
Four members. Maybe we can find other security officers to help us with our overthrow.
Yeah.
So this is obviously a game with only us four, so I don't see the purpose of that.
I think we make Richard...
I think we make him instruct other figures.
We need to throw him for a loop.
No, but I think...
We have.
Yeah, I think we need to do a scan to find out what else is going on the bridge and then transport over there.
Yeah, see what those five...
I think the gas... Because, well, bodies. I think we should try and figure out what to do with the gas because if the Romulans are affected by this gas, we can maybe knock them out before we even get there.
That's true, but we need to find out what's going on. We need to scan the bridge first, though, right? Have them work.
Okay, scan, gas, transport.
Okay, just guess.
Okay. You guys are a trip. All you guys are a trip.
I'm going to begin with scanning.
What are you scanning? Are you scanning
we're going to scan the bridge because we need a success because we need to know if it's Romulan or other.
I'm scanning the bridge. I think I need 12 for that.
Yep, 12. Yep.
1, 3, and 5. So
no, what are you doing? Okay,
try
look,
scanning again.
Scan. Yeah, let Justin scan.
All right, what are the numbers I'm looking for scanning?
Insight and security.
Insight and security. Yeah.
Okay, that's 11. Let me see what I get. By the way, I do have a science tricorder. I forgot I had that. But anyway.
No, you've used it before. Yeah.
Let's see. We have whatever that symbol is. Does that mean 20?
Success. Yep.
Success, and then 4 and 7. 47.
Oh. Unsuccessful.
Come on, that's
got
to be successful in Star Trek. It's got a 47 in it.
You were able to detect five bodies on the bridge.
Damn it, we need to scan more. That's what we know before. I say we keep scanning until we get more.
Amy scans.
Amy scans. There you go.
I need 11 or higher.
I see where this is going. We're just going to keep going around and everybody will scan until we get successful.
It's like we're trying to figure out our username and password.
Yeah.
Is that one? Right? No. Is that one? No.
Did we try password yet?
I can scan.
What's that?
I think Inside. Amy's going to scan, though.
Yeah, Amy's going to scan.
Call me an 11 or higher, please.
11 or higher. Oh, right.
Only roll 11 or higher. If it's lower, roll again.
13, 16, and 5.
Roll again.
No, I should know more than 5 bodies.
29 and 11. All right, here we go.
Okay.
All right, so Amy was able to detect that there were 5 Romulans on the bridge and a good majority of the crew is in the observation lounge.
Wait a minute. There's 1,000 people on this ship. Right, are you sure the good are you sure a majority of them are crammed in the observation lounge?
They're all crammed in there, right? The bridge crew. They're like sardines.
The bridge crew.
It's like there's 950 crew. People in the observation
lounge. The bridge crew, there you go. everyone else is elsewhere, trapped in closets.
But wait, can we tell that the ones in the observation lounge are unconscious or otherwise not available?
Wait, say that again. Sorry.
Well, what can we tell? It's like 5 conscious Romulans, and then
there are 5 conscious. Yep, 5 conscious Romulans in the bridge crews
in the
bridge crews in the observation lounge. Yep.
Dang it! There's only 4 of us.
There are 1, 2.
I say we gas now.
Okay. Yep. We need to
gas on the
bridge. So, okay. Yeah, Richard. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take the gas and put it into the bridge to knock out the Romulans.
Yep.
Oh, that sounds
you did something
familiar.
Right.
It's like ship in a bottle.
We did.
Cool.
Or no. What was it? No, it wasn't ship in a bottle. It was a Voyager episode, wasn't it?
There's several. It's like one of my favorite kind of gas.
No, knocking out Romulans on the bridge. I can't remember.
Oh, that was Message in a Bottle.
Yeah, it was. Okay, cool. All right, so who's doing the control? I assume Nate's doing it or Alvin's doing it.
Yeah, I'll do it.
All right, control.
Just like last
and...
time, we're going to keep rolling until the gas is successful.
control and con.
Oh, I need an 8 or higher.
8, 9, and 10.
Woohoo!
Successful. Ooh, we gassed them.
How was an order like that? Jeez. All right. Anyway, you successfully control the nerazine gas that's in the Jeffries tube, and you fill the bridge, knocking out the crew. Or the Romulan crew.
Wait, but
okay.
But
now that we've done that, I think we need to find a way to vent the gas now before we transport, so we don't get knocked out. When we
Wait. I think what we need to do, if we can, is not just the bridge, but there are those 5 other. I still worry about those 5 other ones we left behind. Don't we need to make sure we gas them as well, or any other Romulan life signs that we see?
All right, you gas them too. They're unconscious. Every Romulan. Unconscious.
Okay, so now we just need to go to the bridge, right, to transport there.
Yep.
Okay, do we need some kind of... Wait,
why don't we...
Alvin's...
Let's transport just outside of the bridge, because then we can open the door and let it vent out before we just...
No, we're going to automatically vent it before we go, right?
Yep, it's already vented. It's already done.
Okay, perfect, then.
So who's transporting?
Transport.
What do you need, for that?
Control and engineering. Oh, no, control and con. Control and con.
I have 12 for that.
So I'm assuming everyone...
I have 11.
We're beaming everyone?
13.
Yeah, we're beaming everyone.
What do you have, Nate? Or control
I have
and con.
5 and 3.
Then we're rolling for you.
18, ahead, 14, 15. Okay. All of you have been transported to the bridge.
Cool.
Successfully.
Yeah, with no ailments.
The bridge.
And we have five knocked out Romulans
Do you have 5 Romulan figures to show tilted over? There we go.
Yes.
They're falling out of the bridge. Yeah.
They're all unconscious.
Excellent.
Congrats, you guys have made it to the bridge. Woo!
Nah, they'll be out for a few hours.
Yeah.
Oh,
we weren't.
Right.
That's because I slapped you.
We can also kill them if it comes to it.
No,
so.
We will not do that.
Now, all of a sudden, the whole entire ship starts shaking multiple times.
Oh my God! More
weapons fire from outside outside the ship is hitting it.
Oh man!
Then I want to scan the computers to get the deflector shields up.
No, don't. Well, don't we can't? Are the consoles operational so we can just man them and try to?
Yeah, the, all power has been restored okay. to the.
Yeah. We need to raise the shields and see what's going on outside.
All right, okay, so, Nate, that's you. Your security.
Raise the shields.
Raising the shields. Wait,
you got to roll for it. Yeah. I can't give you it. So right, control so console
control and
eight.
It's got to be yeah.
9, 9, 14. Okay, shields are up.
Yes.
No problem. No problems are going on now.
Okay, can we hail that ship? See what's going on, or can we find out what kind of ship it is?
Do
we
know if it's a
who's? Wait, she off, has. First off, who's taking con? Who's taking command? Where are you guys going? I mean, you guys just standing there next to the
Amy
view
screen. Should take the con because she has diplomat.
That doesn't might matter. Be able to it's better. If she, actually, right. Amy should be in command, I think.
Yeah.
That's what I said. Amy should be in command.
Oh, yeah. Not
okay,
con.
Slightly different.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Okay,
my bad.
Put me in the captain's chair.
My bad.
Put her in the chair. There we go. And then I guess I'll take, I don't know.
What's your strength?
Mostly science. Can I take a science station? And then, oh, wait, and then
can my guy go into the bathroom? It's been a little while.
Con, yeah.
We need to shoot someone screen. To steer us.
Someone's got to. You know,
there needs to
take
be two people at the consoles up front.
So
let's
Justin,
wake up one of these Romulans.
Justin, you take the con.
All right, fine.
Operations or the actual con?
The actual con. Why not? I can fly this ship.
And I'm just standing looking out the window?
You're pointing at the screen. I don't know what you're doing, dude.
Oh, geez. Put him in
you
ops.
Ops?
Put him in ops.
There
and
you go. Now you guys are. Right,
what
go.
The heck is going on behind us? Is that the science station? At the back?
No, that's weapons.
Weapons. Oh, yeah. Okay. Got it.
Yeah. That's where Alvin is.
No, that's where Nate is. Nate's on weapons.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. My bad.
All right. So, but are we able to see what kind of ship it is?
Okay. So, we're going to open hailing frequencies.
Well, so I'll give you what's here. So the view screen's off, the shields are up, all panels are now lit up and working.
Okay. So we're going to open hailing frequencies.
Okay.
And we're going to inform the Romulans that we have taken control. We have all of their Romulans.
So you're gonna do a command and presence, so 14.
But do we know it's a Romulan ship for sure?
No one scanned or done anything other than read the shields.
Should we find out what kind of ship it is? But
please.
I would like to scan the other ship.
Please right. scan. Right.
So okay, so
who's shooting at us?
Okay, so Alvin, you're in the you're in operations. So that's gonna be. Control
and
con
security,
again. Control and con again. I mean, because you're operating the con.
So I need 11.
11, yep.
I've got 18, 10, and 14.
You were able to detect one Romulan warbird outside.
But there might be more.
No, they're not friendly.
No. That's the only ship.
Oh, okay.
Okay. There's only one enemy ship outside, Amy.
Captain Nellen, do you want to talk
to
me?
What should we do?
All right, well, we need to open hailing frequencies.
That's you. Okay. That's you again, so Alvin.
Okay. Again.
I know you don't know that. You don't
let
know
me
that.
Roll.
Yeah, 11 again.
13, 18, and 4.
Uh-oh. So we have, we can talk, but I can't see him.
Oh, come on.
We can talk, but we don't have visuals.
Who is this I'm talking to?
This is the USS Venture. You have attacked a Federation ship. Please explain yourself.
We want your ship. Prepare to die. And then
I knew you were going to sneak that in.
And then the camera pans to Amy's face, and she gives what command?
Fire.
And the screen turns black.
Oh,
to be continued.
To be continued.
And then it's over. Dang it. So we don't even know if we died.
What?
That's it. That was it.
Yay!
I had a lot more, but you guys went right around all of them.
All right.
I'm like, oh my gosh, really? You guys went right around all of them.
We've been here for.
I had.
Well, with that Romulan warbird outside, it's good we didn't fly outside of the ship.
Yeah. Right,
yeah. Well, down. Yeah. Yeah. I was hoping that was going to happen. That would have ended the adventure right there. But no. No, but like, I had so many things related to DS9. I had traps all over the place, and you guys went right around them. I'm like, great.
Oh, wow.
Good for us. So it was 2 hours instead of three.
A lot of it
had ruined his last episode.
That's okay. That's no big deal.
Thank you, Richard. It was a lot of fun, although for a while I thought it was like Star Trek room-to-room search.
Well, you guys didn't even do that. I mean, I was hoping for like something, but that's okay.
That was a great game of hide-and-seek.
I just enjoyed busting down doors.
And slapping people.
See, she'll never let you live it down. Well, so that is the adventure. I hope you guys enjoy this as much as I did. I planned, like in the last episode, Amy stated that, yes, I have been planning this for about 6 months. And I have been painting figures and everything. Yeah, it's been amazing.
I want to ask Richard, did you actually make up the contents of the adventure, or was that also from Star Trek Adventures?
No, a good portion of it I made. Well, obviously, when you guys started to go into the shuttlecraft, that's when that's when it went out the window. I'm like, oh. So, but like, I mean, like the bridge was already set the way it was, and then same thing with engineering. Yeah, for the most part, it was actually done all by me. So wow, I got a couple ideas.
He's been planning this for a long time. So
yes, yeah. as I've been telling Alvin quite a bit, or not like what's in the story, but that I've been planning.
Yeah,
this
just
for a while.
I've just known he's planning it forever.
Yeah,
amazing. Yeah. Thank you, Richard. So, this is great. Well, yeah. And we have a cliffhanger, so at some point we'll have to finish this. Yeah.
Yeah, we can. Yeah, I mean, I have more to. I have more to the story. If you guys want to finish it, we most certainly can.
Yeah, I want to know what happens. Does the USS Venture survive? Do we get blown out into space? Do we set the self-destruct? You don't know.
Does Nate slap more Romulans?
Yeah, and break down more doors. You know what? Maybe on the next adventure, slivers. We can like transport over to the Romulan ship just so that Nate can break down Romulan doors.
This is a great idea.
Well, any final thoughts from anyone? Did you guys enjoy this? I'm assuming you did.
Oh, for
you
sure.
Did.
That was a lot of fun.
Oh, I had a great time.
Yeah.
Yeah, compared to last time, I love the addition of the boards that we got to see that. And the figures, Richard, are beautiful. You were showing us as they were coming, you know, as you were painting them. They're just wonderful. And it makes you feel more part of the game when you see it. And the board is beautiful. And we're going through and it felt more like a game this time. So I was pretty impressed. And I like that we had... You know, Nate and Alvin with us too, because it felt more of a community, which I hear people say that this type of game is. So very well done.
And,
I loved it.
And by the way, Richard, I took some screenshots while we were going along. I might just post those in the Babel conference when this comes out so people can see what we saw.
Smart. Yeah. Nate, did you have anything?
No, it was fun. I liked slapping people and... busting through doors.
You know, every time you were talking about busting through doors, I was thinking like what is it? I think its name is Rhino from the Spider-Man comics, where he's got like a long horn and he's got this gray suit and then he charges right through walls and everything. That's what I was imagining every time you were like, "I'm on my way."
I was thinking Juggernaut.
Juggernaut
in the X-Men.
Perfect.
Oh, I was thinking Rock Hard and Steady from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
That works. That both those work. That's great.
And I have to ask while you guys are still here. So, like, what kind of familiarity do you have with Star Trek or that you've watched? And just curious.
I have Richard. He's my brother, and he always talks about it. And he sent over a couple episodes for me to watch or listen to. So
yeah, I mean, mine's not the same. Sorry, go ahead.
And I was just saying, I haven't watched it too much, but that's just because of my own busy schedule. But it sounds like a lot of fun and actually kind of fun to listen to and watch.
Oh, nice.
Well, I'd be excited to see more of it.
You guys did a great job considering that.
Yeah. I'd say along the same lines as Nate, my whole Star Trek thing is more with Richard than watching it myself. So, you know, it was a good time to just jump in and give it a try instead of, you know, being hesitant to play the game. So I think it went pretty well.
Nice.
Yeah.
So I know there's been a couple questions about people asking what kind of game this is. So just to give you guys a shout out to Morpheus Games, it's Star Trek Adventure. The core book is where we bring most of the rules. And then, of course, the tiles are actually made by Star Trek Adventures as well. And, I mean, they're done beautifully. I mean, I could have printed these out, but I don't have a printer. So rather than, I mean, it would have cost me like, what, $10? But I sprung out, you know, all these. And these are like I think they're $25.99 or something like that for all, for like almost 50 tiles or something like that. 25 tiles, I mean. And, you know, it's a very awesome game. I mean, this, like I said before, this is like my third time, actually hosting a game, and I absolutely love it. It's amazing. It's so much fun to, make content, and there's plenty of stories that they have on their, website of free stories that anyone can just download and, play the game. I mean, based on the story, I mean, I think they're all approved by CBS and, all the writers over there. Because I don't think they can, because they stamp it CBS property. Oh, yeah.
It's
stamp
definitely officially licensed.
Called. Yeah. So I mean, it's a great game. I really hope that you guys enjoyed it. Like I said, this is my last Earl Grey. I'm not officially gone from the network. We are starting another podcast that I can't really say much right about now, but fear not, I will be here. And, I've really enjoyed, you know, doing shows with you guys.
Yeah. Thank you, Richard. We'll really miss you. And it just needs to be noted here. You've been on Earl Grey for over 120 episodes. So done so much for this show, and we really appreciate everything you've done, and we'll miss you.
Yep. Richard, you're my original, and it's going to be different. Not having you here week after week, we started Earl Grey 2.0, as we lovingly call it behind the scenes, you know, with me, and you brought me in to Earl Grey, and we definitely will miss you. I think our, you know, for me coming to your wedding and, you know, seeing Jennifer when she visits, like, you definitely are a very close Trek friend, and love you, and we'll just have to get you on mic whenever we can.
Yeah.
Damn you, Amy. Oh. You make it sound like I'm dying. No, I'm just kidding. No. I know. Well, I appreciate you guys. I mean, it's really been fun. I mean, like I said, to Amy and Justin, life is getting busy. My daughter's becoming more active in sports and all that kind of stuff, and I need to be there for it. And on top of that, my work life is getting far busier than I really want it to be. But like, you know, gotta pay the bills, right? So
we definitely understand and no qualms whatsoever. Right. We're just gonna miss you. Yeah. That's all.
Yeah. Well, I'm gonna miss you guys too, but I still will be around. I promise.
Yeah.
So next week, Justin, what do we have for next week?
Yeah, next week we will have a special guest on, Chris Trabuzio, and we'll be discussing the Gambit 2-part episode. So I think we're excited for that, right, Amy?
Yeah. So listeners, if you want to be prepared, go ahead and watch that this week, and we'll talk about it next week.
Yeah.
Sweet. I can't wait to hear it. Well, it's been so much fun slapping each other around and breaking through doors, but that isn't the only thing we've been doing here on the network. Here's what you might have missed elsewhere on Trek FM.
Previously on Trek.fm, Melodic Treks.
I dislike the way it sounds, like this kind of marching exploring, searching feeling of, I don't know, it's just something about it that gives you this connection. And it feels like almost like these famous, whether it's like Gunga Din or the Sahara with Humphrey Bogart, it feels like that kind of old movie vibe where they're out in the desert and, you know, they're part of a troop.
Literary Treks.
Yeah, I really wanted to start off the book kind of like basically right after the events that Dave portrays in Control, and just a little bit kind of as, if you remember from the end of Hearts and Minds, when Akkar and Picard are talking, and Akkar is giving Picard the business about all this stuff. I wanted to kind of just step back a couple paces and then run back into it again.
Primitive Culture, a look at history and culture through Star Trek.
I think you're absolutely right with Marina Sirtis, and she, I think she's talked about it, you know, she was sort of saying, you know, what's the accent meant to be? And they were like, well, she's a Betazoid. We never met one before. We don't know what the Betazoid accent is. Make something up. So she sort of made something up. I don't know where she came up with that accent, because it is quite weird, Troy's accent. And it does get progressively less noticeable as Next Gen goes on, to the point where by the movies, I mean, by the time you get to Drunk Troy and First Contact, to me, she just sounds more like Marina Sirtis and less like, you know, less even than kind of Americanized Troy.
Warp 5.
All right, now we are on to episode 3, Extinction. Archer, Reed, and Sato are threatened by a virus that mutates them into primal life forms.
All right, I'll take a break here. I'll see you guys in 5 minutes.
Oh, so then we already know Patrick's one.
So Patrick says no.
Okay, so no. So Brandon, I'd love to hear your take on this, Brandon.
And that's what else is happening on Trek.fm.
Check out all of these shows and join the conversation about your favorite corner of the Star Trek universe and beyond. You'll find us wherever you get your podcast. If you're an Apple user, be sure to hit the subscribe button in Apple Podcasts on iPhone, iPad, or Apple TV, or the desktop iTunes app to get the latest episodes as soon as they are published. And please leave us a star rating and written review. That does help others to find the show.
If you're not an Apple user, we've got you covered as well. You can find our shows on Google Play Music, Stitcher, TuneIn, Spreaker, SoundCloud, YouTube, Windows Phone, and most third-party apps, and you can stream and download the MP3 file from our website or grab the RSS link.
We'd love to hear your thoughts on today's show, and there are many ways you can do that. The best place is to join the larger conversation in the Babel Conference, our listener group on Facebook. Just type Babel, that's B-A-B-E-L, into the search field on Facebook, and it should come right up.
If you'd like to send us an email, you can use the form on our website at trek.fm/contact. Choose to send to a show and select Earl Grey. That will come right to us, and we might read your email on the show. You can also find the network on Twitter at Trek.fm and on Facebook at facebook.com/trek.fm.
So, Justin, where can we contact you when you're not busting down doors?
You mean when I'm not trying to do that? I'm not very successful. I think Nate is the king of that. But when I'm not trying to do that and bouncing off doors, you can find me on Twitter. I'm at TrekFan4747, where I tweet about nothing but Star Trek. And you can find me hanging around the Babel Conference on Facebook. So, Amy, where can people contact you when you're not trying to sense what's happening beyond the next door?
Yeah, I need to work on that, obviously.
Sensing Romulans.
Well, you can find me here on the network. I am on The Edge, which is about our Star Trek Discovery podcast. I'm over on the Fandom Podcast Network talking the Orville and Discovery on Discoville. And I am on Twitter at Miss Amy Nelson, but my favorite place is right there in the Babel Conference. So, Richard, where can people contact you when you're not hosting Earl Grey?
Oh.
Oh. Well, I will return back to the Babel Conference, but for right now, you can't on Facebook, but you can definitely search for me. You guys can find me on Twitter. My handle is xransom, and then, of course, a podcast to be determined and announced at a later date.
All right. Well, if you'd like to help us keep all our shows coming to you each week, you can become a patron of the network on Patreon. Visit patreon.com/trekfm. That's patreon.com/trekfm to get all the details. Perks include early access to episodes, exclusive content, producer credits, and more, available through our special patrons website, The Patron Zone. It requires a great deal of money to produce, host, and distribute these shows each month. We really appreciate any support you can give us and hope you'll join the team. Again, you'll find all the details at patreon.com/trekfm.
We'd like to take this opportunity to recognize our current associate producers, Norman Lau, Justin Ozer, Michael Huter, Thomas Appel, Chris Tribuzio, Joe Keegan, and our newest, Jim McMahon. Thank you for supporting Trek FM and especially Earl Grey.
So join us next time for another cup of Earl Grey.
Things are only impossible until they're not.
Great joy and gratitude.
And this is going to get loud. Today is a good day to die!